All right, this is Randalicious. Welcome to the Fifth Hexes podcast, and let's get right into it. I'm Randalicious, and I'm the leader of Hexes.
I'm Sickener, a general in Hexes and rank 1 overall.
I'm Dance Music, I'm rank 29 cooking.
I'm the Case Ace, or you can call me Chris. Currently going for max, and current rank 55, time to max.
I'm Lelador, and I'm the holder of the infamous Agility Week record.
I'm Matto, and I'm currently going for max 2, about 90 hours away from it.
All right, so first question we got is, when did you start playing old school, and when did you start being efficient in it as well?
I started when Old School was released, so 22nd of February, I think, 2013. And I became efficient when I joined Hexes, because all you noobs taught me a lot.
All right, I started like the second or third day of old school, and I started playing efficiently, I want to say like late March, early April-ish.
I started about a week, nah, 2 weeks after release, and I played like a peasant for the first few months, and then I met Adam during runecrafting, and I think he introduced me to well, you and Randy, and
Did I really? I can't remember.
well, that's also when I started playing efficiently due to axes.
I started playing old school on day one, like the same hour it came out. I remember logging on to play. And I only started playing efficiently like early this year, like maybe February this year.
Oh, sorry, I was distracted. I started about a month late, but I only really started being efficient towards the end of the year, when I joined Hexus and stuff like that. Before then, I just really PVM'd and stuff like that.
Yeah, I started playing April of the year it was released, and I was a bit of a peasant, bit of just like PVM, really like rec casual player type. And Daubs, who was an ex-member of Hexus, introduced me to the clan chat of Hexus. Started hanging out there more, seeing all like the top ranked players in the clan chat was really awesome. And that was from then on, I kind of became efficient. That was like September, October, the year of release.
All right. So, which Slayer tasks do you guys block or cancel, and why? Lala, I think this one's pointing to you on your Iron Man.
All right. Oh, so should I start? Okay.
Go for it.
Yeah. I currently have only three tasks blocked. Iron Dragons, Kalphites, and Hailhounds.
Hell fights, man.
Yeah, they don't drop shit, and I don't have the cannon.
Oh man, I'd
And
hate to be an Iron Man for
same with
that.
Hailhounds, they're awesome XP, but they don't drop anything. And Iron Dragons because they're just slow. And I had elves blocked, but I removed them today just to test them if I can get any decent XP because they drop a lot of herbs and some seeds. And on the fourth, I'll put blue dragons, I think. Oh yeah.
You're using Neve.
Yeah,
Okay.
Neve all the way to 99.
I block spiritual mages, spiritual warriors.
Oh, those are so good.
What?
On Iron
Well, for you.
Man.
And I block gargoyles and necroyles, and fifth slot would probably be cave krakens, because they're shit. And I cancel Pepperdragon, all those random shitty tasks like banshees and scarabites and stuff.
All right, I have the same exact blocks. For the fifth block, though, I would probably do blue dragons. I feel like they're assigned a lot more frequently than Cave Kraken are with Neve. So I
I
don't
don't
know.
think I'll even get the fifth block.
Yeah, it'd probably be real hard to get on an Iron Man. I don't know. I think blue drags are assigned more than Cave Kraken trance.
Yeah, they definitely are.
Oh.
Well, on my block test, I got Spiritual Warriors, Necrials, Gargoyles, and Spiritual Mages. And I'll probably put on one of the dragons, probably. Irons or Steels. I don't know which are assigned that often, but...
I have the exact same blocks as Matt and Trance, so I won't bother repeating that, and I just skip everything. But you can't canon, which is not Abyssal Demons or Krakens.
Alright, Spuddy asks, if protection player prayers were 50% block like they are in RuneScape 3, would you vote to make it 100% block like it currently is in old school? Kind of saying, like, we complain about a lot of OP things. I don't know. What do you guys think? Hypothetically, if they were to pull, you know, like, Protect from Melee, you don't get hit by fucking monsters at all. But changing it to, like, 50%, like, would we vote for it to go from 50% to 100%? I guess is what that's asking.
Yeah. But I kind of like it how it is right now. Like, with power slaying, it's enjoyable. You can do other stuff, and yeah, I guess it's kind of OP. But I wouldn't want it in the game to have a 50% block. But yeah, I don't know. I wouldn't want it in the game.
I think without a doubt, Prayer is the most overpowered skill in the game.
Yeah.
It gives you complete immunity to one attack style and can boost all of your stats by like 20%. That shit's OP, but I think I'm just used to it, so it just, I don't know, it doesn't seem OP, but it really is. It's fucking crazy. But the way the question's asked, it's like, if it was always, you know,
yeah,
50%,
yeah, it's like a hypothetical situation, really.
Well, to be honest, if it was always 50%, I couldn't say, oh, I'm used to 100%, so I'd vote for it. I'd probably vote no, to be honest. Prayer is, even at 50%, it'd be very overpowered, to be honest.
I'm kind of like the opposite opinion, yeah. I don't think it's that OP, because if you think about it, things like bossing and stuff would become a lot harder than what they are currently, and, we don't really have, like, overpowered potions in the game at the moment, so having that kind of, that immunity kind of balances it out. I feel like if we were to change it to 50%, that drops would, like, increase in price drastically. Like, you could see armor hilt going to easily over 120 mil again, and stuff like that. So
I don't even think Amidal would be soloable or even doable like, a small team. You'd need, like, a mass to get one kill.
Exactly. And things like Corp Beast as well would be like even harder than what it is right now if we only had 50% protection prayers. So yeah, I'd definitely vote no for that.
I think it would be nice if the bossing would be harder and if the item prices would go up.
Yeah, me too. I've got all of them.
And but if the 50% block would have always been in the game, like in, then I would probably vote no to 100%, because I don't like making the game easier. But what do you guys think if they pulled to make prayers block only 50% now?
It would not pass.
It wouldn't come close.
Yeah.
Would you vote for 50% prayer blocks? Or would
probably
you keep it at
100? No, I'm just used to
100%. Let me tell you why. This is the most awful question I've ever heard. Because everything that's been released in RuneScape since Prayer came out has been based around the assumption that you can block one specific type of attack. Like, it's a dumbass question. And it needed to be changed in RS3 because RS3's combat system is fucked.
Agreed.
Ooh, shots fired.
Plus one.
I
don't think it would make anything impossible if you couldn't block 100%.
No, but it would like
it make it it would make it harder, but I don't see that as a bad thing.
It would make PvP actually a challenge.
Yeah.
I thought it was an interesting question. I didn't know that prayers were like that in RS3. So
Yeah,
I.
EOC changed it.
Anyway, I mean, I.
You also have 10,000 hit points.
I don't. Well, shit, I don't know shit
Yeah,
about the
but you
game.
also take a lot more damage.
Yeah, but you also have soul split, so.
Yeah, true.
I don't know. Kind of interesting. All right. There was PCFL Bone had a charity live stream where pretty much she tipped a pizza guy like $1,200, somewhere around there.
It was, I
It
think
was
it's
over
two
2K.
point two thousand.
Yeah, guess someone donated 1K
Wow.
after he gave him the money.
Jesus. Right.
Yeah.
That's insane.
What do you guys think about that?
It's kind of a win-win scenario because he didn't really lose any money, but he made his streams. I think he had to have gained a shit ton of followers because he was at like 2K viewers or something at the end of it. Like, he didn't like. No one, because nobody would have donated if it was just like for him, right? It should be like a normal day for him.
Yeah.
I'm glad that I went to someone who deserved it. Make use out of it.
There's an awesome live stream. I fucking actually only slept like 2 or 3 hours so I could actually watch most of it.
Yeah, same.
I think it was just priceless because of the guy's reaction at the end. Like, he broke down pretty much, started hugging him, saying he loves him and stuff. It was so cool to watch. Yeah, it's awesome.
I thought it was really cool. I donated $1. I really liked the dude's reaction. It was great. As Tran said, it was a win-win too, you know. Bone was doing a great thing for the guy, and he was getting a lot of publicity out of it as well. And I wish more people would do stuff like that. That guy, it made that guy so happy.
Yeah, like he was saying, like I didn't have any money, for Christmas presents for my father and my brother, like stuff like that. It just made his day, well, probably his week,
Yeah,
but
probably his year.
Or year.
probably his year. But I mean, people were commenting on Chris Archie's video about how he should have donated it to charity or something like. You're making someone's day, and he's working around the Christmas days for delivering pizzas. I mean, yeah, it's just an overall great thing to do for another human being. It doesn't all the money doesn't have to go to charity because most charities take 50% of the donations anyway.
I think
So,
it's like 10% or something.
yeah, well, you get the general idea, but
Yeah.
and it basically still went to charity because.
Yeah.
He was in need, and it
Yeah.
definitely went to the right person, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And I also watched almost the whole stream, and only slept a few hours. And it was really awesome. I couldn't donate myself because I'm a poor bastard, but I did donate him like 10 million mind runes for his mind rune collection.
Yeah, I
Hey.
saw that. That was awesome.
Yeah, I bought all the mind runes on the market.
Isn't that like
And
50 million mine runes?
yeah,
Yeah. Worth.
and but yeah, I thought it was amazing, and
Yeah,
nothing
definitely.
much else to add. And shout out to Joey, he's a great man.
I really enjoyed seeing it. I only watched the beginning of the stream, like the first, say, 4 or 5 hours, because I had to go to sleep and go to work. But I woke up and watched the highlight of it, and it was amazing to watch. Just seeing like thousands and thousands of like random strangers that play video games come together just to help out one guy that they don't even know, and is possibly on the other side of the world, is just really amazing. Kind of like restores faith in humanity in a way, and I just thought it was an amazing thing that he did. I can't believe that they got over $2,000 in the end. That was
That's
incredible.
that's
It
insane.
peaked at like
Yeah.
2.7K or something.
That's
And there
amazing.
was
I like.
like Bodhi and Skill Specs and all the other big streamers were there.
Yeah. I like how halfway through, like how he like live streamed from like his lounge room or wherever it was, how donations kept rolling in and rolling in and rolling in. It was just awesome to see.
It was. All right. What's the most EHP you guys have gotten in a month? And Explain the methods that you use during that month.
Oh shit, I need to open my
DML time.
the CML,
All right, I'll start it off first then while you find
Okay,
that.
thanks.
I got like 370 EHP in a month, and I got like 19 mil strength XP and like 60 mil thief XP off a Dorg chest. And I think some farming XP was thrown in there as well. But
Okay, so on Lelador, my biggest month was 434 hours, and it was mostly agility, so it's probably quite close to actual hours played. And on my Ironman account, it was like 405 hours, and even though I had a inflated EHP rate from fishing, it was really close to my actual hours played too, because I checked my time played and I was like 98% efficient or something.
wow.
But the
Wow.
fishing was so fast that it went up a lot.
Biggest month is 428, and that was a combination of runecrafting, and I did like a 140-hour runecraft week in there, so that was like a lot of it was that. I normally don't play that much. And then I did Slayer after that, and I went kind of hard in Slayer too.
Most I
Pretty
got in a month
close.
was 476 EHP.
Holy shit.
Mind you, some of
Damn.
that was a little bit over EHP because I did crafting, which I did with air battle staffs, which is a bit over. Smithing with rune bars, which is a bit over. And herb lore, I just did super defenses, and I did nature rune crafting for about a week as well. And then I did farming and stuff like that as well. So I probably played around 420 hours or something, realistically.
But smithing rune bars isn't really over because it
It's like
assumes you
1.3 EHP an hour, I think.
gonna take away the magic XPs.
That's
You're getting double
mm.
what the
But
smith
you
actually
don't
need.
get EHP from magic if you're
Yeah.
doing smithing. It only counts the smithing EHP.
It's weird. I can't. It's different every time, I swear.
My smithing day is only like 50 hours, where if it was based on smithing, it would be like 70.
My highest month used to be around 330, but they changed the Slayer rates, so now it's about 290. But it was back when I was power slaying, and yeah, that's the only thing I did in that month.
Mine wasn't too impressive in terms of hours. I've mainly just been more of a consistent player. But mine was about 270 hours, and I did superheating for smithing and magic and got 99 in those, and then did 99 cooking in that month as well, and with a little bit of farming as well. That was about it.
That's fuck, we're some nerds. All right. What are your guys' stances on overloads, prayer renewals, super prayers, and other things like that coming into the game? And if yes, do you think they should be tradable or no?
OP, 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 OP. I loved hunting Jadinkos in pre-EOC, but I think it's pretty OP for old school. And I don't think we really need those kinds of potions. And I've always been against like making things faster and easier.
Well, you
So
could bring
I
them out, but just rebalance the experience.
Yeah, that's true, and maybe make them less OP too. And the Juju Hunter, oh, Juju Potions, I think they should be untradeable, because that's the way it was in pre-EOC, so I was used to that.
I think the only potion I'd want to see in the game is overloads, and I think I'd only want to see them balanced for PVM only. They were a great potion. I don't think they were too OP, and the fact that we don't have summoning in the game as well really changes the dynamics of how well the potions can be used in game. I think overloads would be the only one that I'd want, and I'd want them to be pretty balanced. So yeah, that's about it.
Do you think the overloads get you from 99 to like 125 or something?
25 and it
And
keeps
it
you
kept you there for
25.
like 6 minutes or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe if it was like, is it 118 from
If it
a
stayed at
super?
118 for a while, I wouldn't mind.
Yeah, that wouldn't be too bad. Especially if you take the damage, like the 500 of 50 HP
Yeah.
damage, but don't get it back.
I voted yes when we had a I think about a year ago they had a poll on adding in like a super prayer potion or something like that. I did vote yes for it. I don't really think it harms the economy in any way, 'cause at the time it was like you had to use a Raynar, Snapegrass, and then something else to add into the potion, and I don't believe it was tradable. But if they are to come out with any of these really big potions, I don't think any of them should be tradable. Like if they come out with overloads, it should be like a level 95 requirement or some shit like that to make 95, 99, I don't know, something real high like that. I don't know what the Juju potion is. So,
They boosted a lot of skills. Like
oh.
farming Juju gave you 30% more yield from herbs.
Fuck.
That was OP as fuck.
Sounds like
That
a
wouldn't even be
lot.
that bad because like we need more herbs in the game.
Yeah,
Like
but
there's not enough herbs around anywhere.
There's
Yeah,
really
but for
not.
Ju the Juju potions for mining it was too OP in my opinion. It just banks your
Oh yeah.
Your ores. So if you were to be in quarry, it's just mining, basically. You don't have to drop any more ores.
I think it only banked like 30% of the ores.
Yeah, but still, that's so. Yeah, it's way less dropping.
Yeah, true.
Super prayers. No, I wouldn't want those. Same for prayer renewals. Overloads, I don't really mind because yeah, what the other guy said, it's just
The
the other guys.
guy.
But yeah, overloads just yeah, like Kay said, it's a bit balanced. If they were to balance it like 119, and yeah, if the damage, if you don't get the HP back after the overload is done. Yeah, that would also be a good option. I don't want them to be too OP for the game.
Guys, Overload's already in the game. What are you guys talking about?
Yeah, so am I.
Well, they are. And if they added him elsewhere, it'd be kind of confusing.
Yeah, true. I don't want any of them in the game. Just because overloads make, PVM and combat quite a lot easier. Prayer renewals and super prayers let you last a lot longer on whatever task or whatever boss you're camping. And Juju potions, I never really used them to be honest, but I think if any of these did come out, they should be. See, I'd say untradeable because it actually gives herb lore a use and makes people want to get it up. But then if they make them untradeable, everyone will start doing tons of herb lore and it'll become really, really expensive because they're pretty much forcing skill non-skillers do a skill they don't want to do just for combat. So I'd probably like them to be tradable, just so you can actually sell them, possibly make some money off them and stuff like that as well.
I'd
But
like
super
for there to be a
combat.
super prayer.
They already released super combat, so if they did overloads that were tradable, it'd be like, why would you buy super combat?
That's true.
I think when they released super combat, they kind of made a statement like, we're not going to release overloads.
Yeah. They said a lot of things in the like last year. We're never gonna release GE. Gonna get pulled next week, cool.
The super prayers, I think when they were first released, they were untradeable, and you had to like grind wyvern bones to make them, so it wasn't even worth getting them.
I like the idea of the super prayer potion. They have like this extended anti-fire potion, which was pulled at the same time as a super prayer potion. And I do kind of like how the extended anti-fire potion works, because I believe it still uses the same ingredients as a normal one, and you just have to add something else into it.
Lava scales.
Yeah, I don't know. I like that. I'd vote for a super prayer.
But the prayer renewal, when they first pulled stamina pots, I voted no just because it would kind of make room crafting faster and make herbler faster. But I kind of gotten used to them now. I don't really mind them.
Yeah.
Fire and rules would be very similar to stamina.
All right. What do you guys think of an in-game version of mouse keys to keep the playing field even and ban-free if used? Because there's a lot of people who use AHK, Windows mouse keys, other shit, and people.
Yes, please, because then we can finally put the fucking argument to bed. I mean, it's so many people consider it abuse and some don't consider it abuse, and if we all were to have like the same mouse keys and the rest, like any third party software or mouse keys would be like bannable, then yeah, it would put the argument to bed, and that will make me happy, and I think a lot more people too.
I use AHK with diagonals, and I'd kind of like it if they just said, "We're gonna give you mouse keys. You can't use anything else, or you're just get instantly banned for it. No exceptions." I wouldn't mind that. I wouldn't
Yeah,
have to worry. I wouldn't have to get hate from people.
it would make it a lot more clearer. Like Checkix always tries to avoid the issue. Like, yeah, we, there's a possibility you can get banned if you use AHK like mouse keys, even though it's like minuscule. I've never been banned. I used AHK like mouse key scripts on Botworlds and had never any problems. But if the in-game mouse keys were like better than Windows mouse keys, like you could adjust them, the drops better, like pixel-wise, then that'd be great.
So sounds like an in-game AHK.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
I would really like that, to be honest, just because then there'd be no more gray area. I fucking hate gray areas. I mean, I understand why they have one, but it's really annoying. But yeah, I'd like them.
I'd like it too, but as Lella said, I would hope it'd be much more user-friendly than Windows mouse keys, 'cause that shit is terrible, and I hope that you would be able to use I guess essentially I would only want it to be AHK because there are people who use laptops who don't have a number pad who can't use Windows mouse keys in the first place. So I would hope you would get to maybe use F keys even. I don't fucking know. Some way like that, but
Maybe you could bind them to whatever keys you wanted.
yeah, 'cause that, I mean, I play on a laptop, so man,
And
I
I
don't.
think Ash said that you could bind the F keys, like to open different interfaces
Yeah.
to any keys. So I don't see the problem doing the same if there were in-game mouse keys.
Yeah. I would like
Yeah,
for
I'm
it
pr
just to clear the air on things.
Definitely, we need that kind of just straight up, here's how it is and here's how it's going to be kind of rule. There's too much of a, as Adam said, too much of a gray area, and gray areas are just terrible. If they were to be an in-game mouse keys, I'd hope they'd be like remappable to wherever we want on the keyboard, because like half the reason I use AHK is because it's just easier to throw them on the left-hand side of my keyboard instead of throwing my arm across my body. So yeah, I would definitely like to see an in-game mouse keys.
I mean, they're never, ever, ever gonna do this.
Probably not. I still use the numpad even though I use AHK, just because
Yeah,
I'm
same.
used to it.
Yep.
And the main reason I switched to AHK from mouse keys is because it's much easier to type in game. Like, I don't need to turn the sticky keys on and off constantly just to type.
That noise though, every time.
Yeah. And the drops are easier to
Yeah, true.
make easier.
All right, do you guys think that the new continent should be introduced with quests, even if it means delaying its release by a bit longer?
I've never liked quests, so I'd have to say no. No more quests, please. Please, no quests. But on the other hand, I don't care for their new continent too much. Like, it's nice. It's a nice update if there's not too many OP training methods there to devalue.
Oh, they will be.
Yeah, probably, but you can always hope. But yeah, no quests, no.
I personally I love them, actually. My first cape was Quest Cape, and I think if they release a new continent and it doesn't have any lore, then it doesn't make any sense in my head.
There can still be lore if you talk to NPCs. You don't need their
quests.
Yeah, but
who's gonna just randomly talk to NPCs?
Well, the guys who are interested in the lore.
Yeah, true, but yeah, I guess bringing out new quests would introduce everybody to
It'd make
the
a lot
lore.
More sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, true, but
hey, look, guys, a massive continent just appeared out of nowhere. Have fun.
Yeah, fair point.
Exactly. Isn't that how the Earth was created?
True. Well, yeah, I would personally like quests, and maybe just a few, and over due time, just release more.
Yeah, I really don't give a shit about the lore, but I guess there's a little bit of me that would want some lore to it. It just wouldn't make sense for it to just appear out of nowhere.
Yeah.
I think the best thing they could possibly do, if they want to get out as fast as possible, is just to make some shitty ass quest like Cook's Assistant, where, you know, you help some guy build a boat and he takes you there. It's like, oh, thanks, pal, and gives you a quest point. And then
sounds
later
like
on,
Lunar
once
Diplomacy.
It's released, yeah, but not as long-winded because, you know, you want to get out quick. So do that, really short quest, and then just add quest later when it's out. Genius, mate.
Yes.
How are you, Adam?
What?
Yeah, I think it would maybe need, like, I don't know, a Grand Master quest would be pretty cool. I always like the idea of a Grand Master quest. I'm not much of a quester, but I do enjoy the, like, if they make a good storyline every now and then, it is enjoyable to do. As everyone said before, that it wouldn't really make sense if something just, you know, appeared out of nowhere. So, yeah, I think, like, a Grandmaster quest would be fun for the new continent.
I don't like quests. I just skip through all the dialogue and follow each point on the quest guide on the wiki.
Same.
That's what most people do. Like, who actually does that shit?
I do that,
to figure
too.
It out. But quests have nice rewards, and if it's actually like a hard quest, it'll make the continent more exclusive, which could be a good thing.
I think they wanted to allow everybody to be able to access it.
Yeah, it'd be Cook's Assistant level quest.
You can't release something that huge and not put quests on it somewhere.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But I mean, they could do just, you know, just random ass quests, and you get another Slayer block. I wonder if you'll get 6 blocks.
That would be a lot. That would be so many blocks. All right, but what are your guys' opinion on the ZMI altar?
ZMI, if it was released as it was in pre-EOC or in 2008 or whenever it came out, I'd vote no because it was really fast XP and cheap. I think it was like 55 to 60k.
Yep.
And that would make it make getting 91 even faster than it is now, and cheap. And you can still get like 60k an hour doing lavas. It's just expensive. So I don't think we need the MI really. If you want fast XP, do lavas. If you want money, do Abyss or Astrals or something.
I'd only vote for ZMI if it was like rebalanced. I mean, I don't think it'd be too bad if it was around 35 to 40k an hour. But I mean, if you want the best XP rate, you should be doing lavas, which actually costs money. It's a lot of effort versus ZMI, which is slightly profitable, and I've heard it's pretty laid back as well, so that definitely should be the best XP in the game.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth, Adam. I mean, yes, I would like ZMI. I like how you have to Like the zero tick with the altar and entering the dungeon itself, like those little things. It was just I personally love doing ZMI, but I don't like the XP rate. It's just way too overpowered. Like if you want fast runecrafting XP, you should pay for it. But if it was like 30 to 35K, like a bit like Astral's, then yes, I would like it to be introduced to the game.
Would it make, like, would it change EHP rates?
I don't know,
Probably.
Foot's a lazy fuck, so probably
If it
not.
were more than double the rate of Nats and you broke even or made a little money, it would should definitely change it.
Yeah, I'd lose so many hours. RIP.
I don't think Foot might not change it, but it should be.
I think at that point you'd definitely want to be using alternate accounts to make money if ZMI was out.
Yeah.
Because you'd
Yeah.
be missing out on so much time if you didn't.
Altscape.
Iron Man, please.
I watched Phoenix Odin. I watched a few videos of him doing ZMI, and it looked pretty fun.
Yeah.
Looked fun to do. I don't think it has a place in this game though. Like you guys are saying, you'd be okay with it if it was anywhere from like 30 to 40K an hour. But I mean, it still wouldn't even be worth it at that point because you could do Astrals and get over 30K an hour and make nearly 500K GP an hour.
Isn't ZMI like 300K an hour profit? I think it is something like that.
Ish, yeah.
It
Plus,
I
it gives
just
soul
don't I
runes
just
and
don't really
stuff.
think it has a place in the game.
Oh yeah, it would give souls and blood runes.
Yes.
Just doesn't really have a place in the game, I guess. If it came out, I
I
wouldn't want it to be like rebalanced XP wise, because it wouldn't really be worth even doing if it was down to like 30, 35K an hour.
What they could do is they have it in the archive, so you put the underground dungeon on the new continent, but make it far enough away from a bank and teleport spots to where the time it takes to get there would make it about 40K an hour.
Yeah, that's that would be
40K, that's
something.
still too fast in my opinion.
40K with no profit would change much.
It's an interesting topic. I wonder if they'll pull it in this upcoming year. We'll
It
have
would
to
make
see.
sense to put it on the continent.
We'll have
You
to
don't have to
see.
put it in Orianna or whatever it is.
They should release the Blood Altar instead, because you'd get like 35K doing Bloods and Deaths through Abyss.
But didn't they say the new continent, like there's like four like families and they each specialize in different skills. I think one of them was runecrafting.
Yep.
So like, what are
Yeah.
they going to give you for that? Blood
Souls.
Altar maybe?
Souls.
Probably a soul, probably.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Not sure why they're trying to
Not
do
ZMI.
souls. There is literally no fucking demand for soul runes.
Charged Dragonstone Jewelry.
But
That's
yeah,
that's
that'll be
not
there.
much of a demand whatsoever. I think it should be bloods, like PKers use those all the time.
They're not really. Like a few hybridism is not many of them anyway.
For
Blood runes will end up
So
being like
soul
two.
soul
They'll
runes you
become
soul
insane.
runes really have no use in the game though.
Maybe they could make like a spell which extends your splashing time from 6 to 12 hours with soul runes. That'd be good. Yeah, 1K soul runes, that'd be good.
It's funny how in the RS3 in Abyss there's the soul rift, but still no soul altar.
Think that's in here on old school too.
Yeah,
Yeah.
but it's been like in RS3 it's been there for 10 years or something. Still no update.
Alright, moving on. Would you guys vote yes if they repulled the ability to use the space bar to go through chat boxes and numbers to choose from the chat options?
Yeah, I would definitely like that because, well, mainly for quests, it would be easier if people don't want to read the lore and the dialogues. People can just spam click the space bar, and you don't mi like misclick the options as much as like click here to continue, and then you accidentally click one of the options. Yeah, I would like that in the game.
Yeah, me too. I'm pretty much the same about just spamming through dialogue that you don't want to have to read through. Really like sped up quests a little bit as well. Yeah, just made getting through boring dialogue pretty easy. So I'd definitely vote yes for that.
I'm gonna say it'd make construction easier, but they already did
Yeah.
that.
So, I don't. Yeah, I don't like it. How close was it to passing?
It was like 2% off because one or two salty kids voted no for it.
Yeah, they'll recall it. My only concern with it is like, will it change the interface or how the chat box looks on the dialogues? Because in pre-OC when they introduced it, it changed it and how the chat box looks, and I didn't like the change. So if it would stay the same, then I'd have no problems.
I don't want them to do it because I don't want them to repoll a lot of other shit that nearly passed.
Well,
I don't want them to do the near pass poll thing. Like, that's stupid.
They'll do it anyway, so
I don't know.
might as well
I
add
think
that
that they
one
should
instead.
have a near miss poll. Like there, I think there are a lot of things that were 70 to like 74% that didn't pass that I think should have. And I know that making units grimy was only like 50-50, but I think that would pass if it was polled now.
Oh yeah, please, that one. That make my life so much
I think
easier.
there. I think there's a lot of. I think there. Sh they should come out with a re-poll of things that almost passed. And
Okay, what about things that barely passed? Like Night Zone's on like 77%. Are you gonna re-poll that? Because a lot of people have changed their
please
minds about it
do.
since it came out. Exactly. Like if you do near miss, you have to do near pass too.
Ooh.
Yeah, true.
I agree.
That just makes sense. Nightmare Zone would definitely not pass. I would have never voted yes for it if I knew it was going to be as OP as it is.
But you
Yeah.
voted yes.
I voted no.
Yeah, I voted yes because it was a fun mini game to fight quest bosses.
Think about how many people are like 126 combat with 40 Slayer right now. Like, where would they be without Nightmare Zone? Where would you train combat without Slayer? Yeah,
In
but we didn't
Farmville.
know that that would happen when
Yeah,
Okay.
I know,
I'm just
I
kidding.
voted no for it when it was pulled because I didn't want them to waste dev time on it.
Yeah, same.
They
that was
weren't
really
developing
it.
anything at the time. It was like the first update in the entire year. Like everyone was so desperate for any update, they just voted for anything at that point.
I just thought it was useless.
I didn't want the
But
dev time being spent on it. All right, moving on. What do you guys think about Botsaw losing his Iron Man status?
Oh, here we
See
go.
ya.
Well, he did cheat, so I think it's only fair that he lost his emblem. But then again, there was a lot of people who did cheat and didn't lose their Iron Man status.
Call him out.
Call him out.
I think that everyone who cheated should have lost their even though Jagex, of course, didn't do it because they'd lose so many members.
I
But
have so
yeah.
many different opinions about this, and I'm probably gonna get shit for saying stuff, but I understand why he's pissed off, because at the end of the day, Jagex didn't really, they did kind of just ignore it for so long, so everyone assumed, okay, we can do this as much as we want, but you know, if you make an Iron Man and start using your main account for your Iron Man,
Yeah, what's the
you're not an
point?
Iron Man. Like, what's the point? You just got a normal account. And everyone's acting like he's been banned. He didn't get banned, he still got all of his stuff. And he didn't play as an Iron Man in the first place, so what's the big deal?
Yeah.
But if I was him, I would be pissed off, but at the end of the day, he did cheat.
Yeah, I pretty much have the same opinion there. The whole idea of being an Iron Man is to be, a self-sufficient account, gather everything yourself. If you're using your main to basically transfer things to your Iron Man, it's really not in the spirit and not how the game format was intended to be played. So I definitely think it was good that his status got revoked. But I think Jagex needs to be consistent across the board with things like that. If they're going to, remove his status, then make sure they try and remove other people's statuses.
Oh yeah, they
Yeah.
didn't remove like most of the people. Like if you look at the crafting high scores, like let's look at the top guy right now. Okay. Crafting Wait,
Well,
Paul?
I
Paul
think
Rudd?
Paul
I
Rudd,
see
yeah.
it there, mate.
I'm not. I'm.
Anyway,
If
he's
it
got
seemed.
22 runecrafting, so he doesn't have cosmic runes for the air orbs, and he's got no other skill to make money. He's just got crafting. So where did he get that stuff?
Shit.
I wonder.
Steel plates.
To be fair, he does have 72 smithing, but is that enough?
Well, what's this
No
magic
way.
level?
78. I guess he
Yeah,
could,
you could
but
alk it.
yeah, but he could be alking the ones he got from the shop.
How is he gonna
Yeah.
alk it if he has 22 runecrafting?
Well, you don't need to
He
do
can
is
buys
buys all
gnats
the
from the shop
gnats.
as well.
But you only need
Yeah.
to do if you're doing battle stuff, so you only need like a few mil starting cash and then you start making profit from the staffs.
That's
Yeah.
true. But either way, not just that guy, I'm not like calling him out or anything, but how many people have probably done it who haven't been
Yeah.
banned? Like,
A
one
lot.
of my
None of them
friends
have
got
been
privileges
banned.
revoked as well. Well, not banned, you know what I mean? Revoked.
Yeah, I think they should
I
have,
think
like.
it's unfair to, take it off Bonesaw and not take it off everyone else.
Yeah.
Who's done it?
He was saying that him streaming, all the advertising he does for the game should make him immune.
Oh yeah, I thought that was ridiculous. It was
I
hilarious.
Yeah. He's
couldn't
so
believe what I was
entitled as
hearing when he
well.
was saying that he doesn't even want to advertise for them anymore, and that they should be thankful for all the advertising that he does.
Wasn't
And
him, it just was some other dude. Like, how many people stream RuneScape?
well, I just think it was terrible that he thought he should be immune due to that. He ended up making a video as well explaining that he lost his Iron Man status. On that video, he had the likes and dislikes disabled,
Yeah,
and
the comment approval one.
comments were comment
Yeah.
approved.
He also said on the vid that he never like hide it from anyone, but any time anyone asked about him cheating or using his main on his streams, they get banned
Yeah, I got
instantly.
demodded and
And
banned from his
on
stream,
his like
and another one of
progress,
my friends did as well.
yeah, and I lost mod on there too, even though I never said anything like about him.
He's a piece of
And
shit person.
on the vid, on the progress vids, he never showed his like methods, how he got the supplies. So he definitely tried to hide it, even though everyone knew he was using his main.
Yeah, the only thing I gotta say after all that has been said is that justice has been served. I think.
I've actually got one more bit of salt to throw his way. In his video, he said, "Oh, I put so much work into this account," which he probably did, but his like reason was, "I have 46 days playtime
Oh, yeah.
in
Forty-nine,
2 months.
49.
I've pretty much never logged off. I put so much time into this, but it's like 90 something magic from splashing. I think it was like 12 mil XP,
He was ranked 2
which if you did
magic.
that with mind runes,
He didn't do mind runes the whole
that's
time. He did not.
okay. Let's just say it was 1,000 hours with mind runes. Let's assume he did chaos as well. That's still more than half of his playtime splashing, so that reason is so bullshit.
Yeah,
Okay, end rant.
Dude's a piece of shit.
I have nothing against him as a person, but his
I don't have
play
anything
style.
against him as a person, it's just the
Yeah.
actual Iron Man account I don't like.
Alright. Hexus Wannabe says, "So what happens after RuneScape?"
RuneScape is eternal, okay? RuneScape will never die. You know
Wanna
why?
bet?
Cause love is eternal, and RuneScape is love. Science right there.
Good answer.
Why?
I'm probably gonna become an MLG Farmville player. Right.
Oh, it's me. Yeah, nothing to add. Trans said everything that's needed to say. Like, RuneScape is life. RuneScape is love. The end.
All right. Well, what happens after RuneScape? Probably death. I don't know.
Skateboard die.
I don't know. If RuneScape was to ever like die out or something, or Jagex sell out again and include microtransactions or whatever, I'd probably go back to playing something like Call of Duty. I was a big Call of Duty player a few years ago and really enjoyed that game, so that's probably what I'd be doing.
That's what I'll do as well as a serious answer.
Yeah, for me, I would just move on and go to Xbox.
You think if they ever dropped Old School, would someone need make a private server and people would play it? Because I know there was like a 2006 Scape that was like
Oh,
in
yeah.
production, and they
Yeah.
dropped it when Old School came out because nobody was going to play it with Old School.
Well, I wouldn't play that. I would just go straight to Xbox and just
I was
start playing
gonna
on it.
play that. I was actually gonna
Yeah.
play that, and then
Yeah,
Old School came
I
out.
probably wouldn't play
Yeah, I
private
wouldn't
service.
play a private server. It would probably get taken down anyway because of copyright. It'd get like 200 more runecrafting and take it down. It's like, oh.
That's a serious answer, like some of you said. I have no idea what I would do if RuneScape like stopped existing. I'd probably just cry
End it all.
weeks straight. Yeah, or kill
When
myself.
RuneScape ends, I end.
Hence
Because,
death.
yeah.
All right, what is your guys' opinion on the old school subreddit? Shit, shit,
Wait.
someone got a dick in my throat. All right.
All right. I don't know. I don't really spend much time on the old school subreddit. I don't even have an account on Reddit, but occasionally, so the guys will link something in the shout box on the offsite, and I'll have a look at it. Some of the things there are pretty funny to look at. Randy's got to be like the most hated person on Reddit.
Hey, people don't hate me as much anymore. Although I
Anymore.
haven't ch
Yeah,
I
they
have
hate Sick Nerd
I
now.
haven't changed. I'm still an asshole. But I don't get as much hate.
Yeah, but I'm yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I don't. I used to go on the subreddit a lot, but I don't know how it is these days. But back when I was there, it was a bunch of hate from everyone. Really, just the comments weren't that friendly. And if you compare old school Reddit to the RS3 subreddit, the RS3 subreddit is way like. The
Oh, it's so much
community there
better.
is way better. I don't know what's the cause of that, but I don't know. I don't go on there as much anymore, but
I know the cause of it. It's because if you give players all the fucking power, everyone thinks they're a fucking politician.
yeah, true. True.
R states for casuals.
I go on the subreddit every day. I wish I didn't. But I just keep going back just to look at shit. I don't really like it, but at the same time, I don't know. I guess it's like an addiction that I don't like. I guess you could maybe say it'd be like cigarette smoking, I guess. You don't
It
like,
feeds you.
yeah, you don't,
Guilty.
you don't like it, but you still want to do it. I don't know. That's me.
The old school subreddit is my favorite place on the internet to troll. That is where I get my trolling fix.
I think your trolling got a lot better recently, to be honest. So good job.
Thanks,
Especially with
man.
that
That means a lot.
massive, like, fucking Runelink board next to your name so you stand out all
Oh my,
the
hey, that
time.
flare is fucking massive.
Thank
It
you.
is.
That's the only reason I did it, just to get the flare.
I don't use sub and Reddit too much. I usually scroll through it once a day, especially if I'm doing something AFK on RuneScape. But yeah, the comments aren't really nice. Like if there's someone getting 99 and most people grat him, but there's always someone flaming him or insulting them for no apparent reason.
I'm pretty biased about the old school Reddit, to be honest, because pretty much if you're a streamer or YouTuber on Reddit, have fun. It's gonna be good. But yeah, regardless of all the shit I get on Reddit, I still pretty much look at every single post that ever comes on it just because I have nothing better to do. So yeah.
Nice life.
Bad.
I know.
I feel the same way about that a little bit. All right. Would you guys like the not the GE, but how about automated trading to come into old school?
Oh, I've got two sides on it, because, like, I would fucking love automated trading slash GE, because it'd just make life so much fucking easier. You wouldn't have to, like, deal with that one guy who's, like, been trying to sell you a magic seed and gives you his life story. I just got it from an oak tree behind a bank. Oh my god. And
what?
anyway, like,
What?
and then if literally, I've had a guy, I'm not even kidding, I've had a guy who gives me the fucking life story of the magic seed. I was like, I was chopping an oak tree behind Draenor Bank. I'm so excited, I'm gonna be able to buy an obby cave, I'm gonna be able to buy everything. Where are you? Can you come my world? Oh my god, it's
My
like
world trainer,
fucking
please.
it's ridiculous, dude. Like, you wouldn't have to deal with any of those people. But then on the other side of it, if a G is in the game, you don't have to deal with those people, so it's a lot easier and less annoying. So I'm on the fence, honestly, but yeah, fuck those guys who do that, by the way.
I'm pretty much for it, definitely for it. I think it was a very, like, not a very good update, but it made things a lot easier in RuneScape. Banking certain buybles at the moment is kind of tedious. You know, you do like 1,000 trades just to do like bank herblore or something, and things like that will just become a lot easier. If they don't implement a GE, I think they definitely need to update the current trading post at the moment anyway. It's pretty shit. People posting offers when their PM's on friends or PM is off, that's just like one of the most annoying things. So yeah, definitely
Yeah,
before a
fuck those
GE type
guys.
update. So annoying.
I'm doing it right now.
Exposed.
Yeah, I really don't care either way, so I'll abstain myself from this
Classic
question.
Iron
But
Man.
yeah, Iron Man for life. But Adam's lovely story reminds me that I had a similar
Based on a true story, it's not a lie.
yeah. There was the same happened to me. There was like this total noob who sold me one magic seed, and he was hyped, so I paid him 200k for it just to make his day.
What a nice guy.
And then 5 minutes later, they PM me back and like, "Oh, I also have a palm seed." They try to sell them all. Like, they don't look at your
I
page
got this
either.
one
They're like,
behind
"Have you seen?"
Folly Bank.
I definitely want instant trading. I don't know if I want that to be a GE. I think GE makes things a lot more expensive. It's a lot easier to merch.
Yep, I'll get in on that hype.
Yeah, I mean, I would merch. I would buy, whatever's good to merch. I don't know.
I'd like any form of automated trading, whether it's the GE or not. I would like it to be in the game, and I'll settle for anything to get it, I guess.
Yeah, I would like it, but I just feel sorry for people like Atsk, who spent so many hours buying shit. It just would really devalue farming, in my opinion, and it would
The
really
hardest part
def
about farming is probably banking it.
yeah and it's the same goes for Herblore. It would just devalue the achievement, in my opinion.
Yeah, but it would make those skills more expensive, so if you did it before the GE, you saved a lot of money.
Yeah, that's true, but I mean, you just have to runecraft a few more hours and you just buy
I
like
think
200 mil in one go.
mage shields go up to like 135k.
They're at that right
Between
now.
the I buy mine 115
I
and
sold
one fifteen.
150k of them last week for 140.
What?
You sold the whole
Oh my! Hey,
GC.
hey, hey! Okay. My bad. All right. I sold 145. No, let me get my numbers straight. Okay, I sold a
You
hundred
almost just leaked the Hexus
I
method.
sold 157 of them for 145k each.
Wow.
I've bought like 60 in the past 2 days for 115, which
Wow.
is like kind of slow buying, but it's so cheap that it's worth it. And with the GE, I wouldn't be able to do that.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, like,
That's true.
No,
I
Ask
know. I know a lot of people. I know a
100K.
lot of people will say that automated trading will cause the prices of most things to go up. Well, the economy's pretty fucked for most skills right now, anyway. So, I mean, there's gonna be a point
I
where.
disagree with that.
What do you mean?
What skills fucked, would you say?
Herb lore is...
Well, that's just because everyone's desperate and not enough people actually need potions. Like, I wouldn't say it's fucked, it's just no one really wants to buy 10,000 super defenses.
Try to buy the supply. It's hard as a bitch to get to the... It's not only hard as a bitch to get the supplies, you gotta go through hell and back to sell your shit, too.
Yeah, but that's because, like, no... At the end of the day, anybody who's gonna go kill, like, bandos isn't gonna buy 10,000 super defenses. It's gonna buy, like, 10. Or 100.
Yeah,
the skills.
Are they?
Bad.
Are there more people training Herblore right now because of achievement diaries? Like a lot more, or is it?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, because it isn't it like 90 for
yeah.
Elite?
90 something, yeah.
Yeah, that'll be so hard on Iron Man.
Oh, definitely.
And the 91 farming too.
Also, Edsk made like 2 bill from Turtles, so I don't care if his shit gets devalued. He made fucking bank off that.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Offense, Edsk.
Yeah, he did. Alright, what would be your main concern on adding new skills to the game? Don't take the stance of you wouldn't add any skills. What would be your main concern in adding to the game, though?
Main concern would be it affecting too many other skills. I guess like summoning. Summoning. Like, the Granite Lobster, like how much is that? Like, 4k an hour? That's not a big deal. But the Pakyak, where it makes EM and Slayer, like, 20% faster, that's too much.
I wouldn't say it makes it faster, it just makes it more profitable, because you can bank more shit.
Yeah.
Well, and the PVM, you know, you can last longer. I've never really used summoning. I think I had, like, 70 summoning, so I never really got to use any of the really OP stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think there's too much OP stuff in summoning, but it makes everything a lot easier.
The two things that come to mind is Pakyak and Unicorn. Those fuckers are OP as hell.
I really like the Unicorn.
Bunyip's fine.
Unicorn is better. I don't know.
Yeah, but I don't see, like, as a new skill would be added. Like, if you add a new gathering skill, that would be just a single skill, like, you have woodcutting, and you have fire making and fletching, and you have mining, and you have smithing. Like, a new gathering skill could be an option.
Yeah,
but then what
would you
do with the stuff you gather?
What
could you gather? Because you can pretty much gather anything that you could think
if
of gathering.
Yeah, exactly, but...
Divination,
like,
mate.
I don't know. Yeah.
If you make a gathering skill, you'd have to make another resource-using skill.
Yeah,
but
what
resource could you possibly gather? That's the question.
Water.
It makes
water.
Some kind of, like,
yeah. Water boying.
Yeah, but I don't, the main concern would be, I have no idea actually. Like, yeah, maybe devalue other skills, other achievements. But yeah, that's kind of mandatory. But I don't know.
I really like the summoning skill, and I thought it was pretty nice. I don't think that it should be in the game right now, but I don't know. I think a skill like summoning would kind of be good, how it does impact a lot of skills. Just a slight. I really have no clue. I'm not a content developer. Fuck it.
My only concern about it is it make, like, something getting past QA, like in Dungeoneering, if anyone remembers, like, the first week runecrafting was ridiculous in Dungeoneering. You could get 99 really quick. Something like that coming through. I wouldn't like that.
Yeah, my main concern's got to be, I think adding, new OP weapons, like, when Dungeoneering came out, they added, like, all the new Chaotics and things, and it sort of changed how PVM and PKing was. I wouldn't want anything too OP or too sort of game-changing in a way. Yeah, so that'd be my main concern, really.
I think most people want a new skill, but not enough people can agree on one skill that they like.
Mm-hmm.
However...
I agree. Well,
people are familiar with summoning, no pun intended. you know,
I definitely think there was a pun intended there.
Yeah. It took a few seconds.
Like artisan, like people, there's some gray areas in artisan where they can kind of fuck it up. People know what to expect with summoning, so it has a greater chance of passing than any other skill they can come up with, in my opinion.
Yes, coming off of that, I heard Mod Matt K talking about this, and... Yeah, I will praise him for a minute here. When he was talking about Artisan failing and exploring the option of adding a new skill, he said that if they were going to add a new skill, they would look into it being summoning or dungeoneering, something that the people are more familiar with. And I think that would be the best route of trying to introduce a new skill.
The only skill I'd actually want out of the ones in Arrow 3 would be Dungeoneering, just because it looks really fun, with nerfed rewards. Summoning and Divination are
Did you
overpowered, in
ever
my
do
opinion.
much? Did you do much dungeoneering at all?
No, but I've heard it's amazing.
Yeah, it was really good. It was probably my favorite skill on RS3.
I have, as long as there weren't any like incidental training methods like C2 fishing and woodcutting. Because like when they
Yeah, I
release
don't like that.
Dungeoneering, I really doubt they purposely added those two things. There's sort of just like
Yeah.
these incidental things that
Yeah,
kind
so
of
for Nightmare Zone,
accident.
really.
Outside training, dead content, like Teeks are dead content if they do that.
Dungeoneering was fun only when you knew how to do it. Like, I was 110 dungeoneering before I actually know what I was doing, and before that I just hated the skill. It was horrible.
It.
And I don't like the aspect that you're dependent on other people, like you have to five-man team it to get the best XP. So if they were to add it to old school, I'd like it to be like soloable. Like the
Yeah.
XP rate would be the exact same,
Yeah,
no
exactly. That.
matter how many people were doing it.
That's why I never got Dungeoneering that high. I got it to like 85 and for Frost Dragons, and it's the only thing I basically did it for. But I really hated like the team aspect. It's not necessarily that I hate like communicating with other people. It's just I don't like having to be dependent on other people.
Yeah.
I think
But
Dungeoneer.
otherwise, I like Dungeoneering.
I think
It was a
Dungeoneering would be
decent skill.
cool. I have never done it, didn't play then, but I would like there to be some kind of team-based skill or something like that. It seems like it'd be fun being part of a team.
Yeah. It was a
Yeah.
shame that that raiding skill didn't pass
Man, hey, that
Nahas
really
playtesting
was the.
content.
I thought it was by far the best skill
Yeah.
suggestion. It's a shame that there were like three dog shit ones that made that pull.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Back in May or
Fucking
whenever that
herding
was.
and shit.
Huh?
That was so bad.
What was?
Herding.
Oh.
Like, what the fuck was herding?
Raiding.
I think it was called herding.
Raiding was a really good idea. And
Yeah,
it
I
would
think it
think
was
so
good.
too, man. It would have been a fantastic way to introduce a whole bunch of or not a whole bunch of new, but make it to where we could like go on a raid this fucking village and get like magic logs. And just other shit like that for training.
Sounds like a mini game.
I guess kind of like a mini game type of thing, but isn't
Just like Dungeoneering.
a lot of people say that's what dungeoneering is too.
Yeah.
Dungeoneering is a mini game, but yeah.
Yeah, but even if they didn't add Dungeoneering as a skill, they could still add it as a like playable mini game where you could race or have a high scores of the fastest floors or
As long as
something
the
like
reward
that.
was good, I'd do it. Like money or just
Yeah.
items.
Something not too OP. That's like our favorite expression, OP,
Yeah,
too OP.
not too OP. Or don't want to increase the XP rate.
Wonder how many times that that's been said so far today. But all right, there is a guy who posted on Reddit. There was some guy who kept ragging him while they were PKing, and like this dude would just like try to spec him out, tell you way. He was just ragging him and shit like that. And later on, this guy eventually killed the ragger, and that dude lost full void. And the guy who was previously getting ragged went out of his way to like barrage him and make sure that he ended up losing his void. You know, like for us, like I guess it would be like someone blocking us from getting our like pouches back for RuneCraft, and that's essentially what he did. But it was,
Yeah, see, a
but it
dead
was,
end. What do you
it.
get?
So the ragger lost his void.
Yeah. I
That's
thought that was fantastic. I mean,
yeah, that's awesome.
dude's a bitch and he
That
had it
is.
coming.
Served it.
Yeah, definitely deserves it. I mean, if you play harassment, it's just so fucking sad. Like, yeah, Transcat ragged a few days ago for his prospector. I mean, it takes quite a few hours to get the outfit, and it's just sad that people, yeah, it's just real sad. that people rag it, but it, yeah. Once again, justice has been served.
Yeah, I mean, I actually got it back barely. I survived 3 Dark Bow specs. I don't know how I got it back. I probably should have lost it.
Like, Ash one tank.
I had a chance of getting it back. But I mean, that's the risk you take going to the wilderness, even if you weren't ragging somebody. Like, I would have accepted that, because using the Abyss is a privilege, and I risk going to the Wildy to use it.
Yeah, true.
Didn't think of, like, Black Shins.
Alright.
Yeah, but then again, that same applies to the Ragger. Like, it was the Wilderness, so...
Yeah, that's also true.
So, he can't complain about losing his Void.
Even if it wasn't deserved, I wouldn't really care. That's a risky take.
Yeah.
I mean, there's being an asshole, though, and there's just getting what was coming to you. And I think that he deserved to lose his shit if he's going around ragging people.
Oh, definitely. He definitely deserved to lose it.
All right, so moving on. What do you guys think about... All right, hold on. Carl from Reddit asks, what do you guys think about adding more bonus XP skilling suits like we currently have with woodcutting and mining?
I think they're unnecessary, but if they only gave like 2.5%, I think it is,
of current 2.5. Outfits.
Yeah, it's not too OP. So I wouldn't be against it if they had a good way of introducing them, not the BH job. Fuck that shit. But I don't think we really need them. It's not. It won't save you that much time.
Yeah, I mean, the game was launched with for Jack. So, I mean, one thing that's not necessary is the Varrock chest plate, though. 10%.
The skilling suits are honestly one of the worst threats to old school RuneScape, I think, because it could mean the end of Fashionscape as we know it. Because nobody will be able to wear fedoras. Nobody will be able to wear just cool shit because they've got skilling outfits on.
Fuck Fashionscape.
Terrible. It's honestly the biggest risk we have of losing old school. And we've just £2 a month will help save a fedora in need. Alright, I'm done.
What?
Well, I would like them for gathering skills, not for like buyables. Mainly because it also takes some time to get the outfits for like it isn't efficient to get Lumberjack from Max if it's above 4 hours, right?
I don't remember what the exact time was.
Yeah, about 4 hours, I think. And, yeah, stuff like that, I kind of like it. Prospector, it also takes quite a lot of time to get. If it takes effort, get the outfits, then I'm good with it. And it shouldn't be higher than 2.5%.
Yeah, I think a good little, like, add-on question for this question is, what skills could we, like, make them for? I was thinking fishing. Maybe you could thieving, yeah, and fishing as well.
Agility.
Yeah.
Well, thieving, the Black Ibis, right?
Yeah.
Is that an RS3 thing?
Yeah.
What is that?
But it came out like 2010.
It's get it. The like same.
A small
it's,
chance.
Yeah, 2.5% boost and some.
Get it from what? Pyramid Plunder.
Yeah.
Was it?
But it didn't work in Pyramid Plunder for the longest time.
Yeah.
Even though you got it from there, it didn't work there. Like, it didn't give the bonus XP.
They're already adding a Addy Cape, which is 10% more thieving XP, so, yeah.
No, fuck no, him, man. No, it's 10% less chance of getting caught, which is like a 4% boost to Pyramid Plunder, if it even works Pyramid Plunder.
It does. Fuck it, what? I feel robbed because I did thieving, I'm salty.
Should have did Doric Chess. I would like for there chess. To be... I would like for there to be some more skilling suits. I don't know what skills we would put them on. I think maybe if we came out with like a mini game or something like that, I don't know. I guess maybe kind of like tying the concept of Barbarian Assault in hold on, not Barbarian Assault, but kind of like you got to work at one mini game to get some points, and then you can use those points to get like the suit. I don't know, something like that I think would be a good way to introduce it.
I think a better way to introduce it would be, because everyone seems to want Stealing Creation, but a lot of people don't want the double XP tools. They could just add Stealing Creation with outfits you can buy that give the 2.5%.
Perfect.
And that
Yeah.
pleases the
But
people who want Stealing Creation.
yeah, that feels like a
And
step towards bonus
Oh,
XP,
I don't
more
want
bonus
it, but
XP and
that would be a fair compromise, I think.
yeah.
But I wouldn't really want it, to be honest. But still, I think that's an alright idea.
But as a principle, I don't like adding any bonus XP, even though it's
Yeah, nor do I.
like only a 2.5%, but it's still
Hey,
going
two point
towards
five
more
percent.
bonus XP
Two point
and
five
more.
percent of a skill like runecrafting is hundreds of hours.
Oh yeah, no runecrafting outfit, please.
Right, what?
Trying to make a runecrafting outfit. Artisan.
Well, that got downvoted to hell and ended up getting removed ultimately before it was pulled. I thought Artisan had a real good chance at making it through,
So glad it didn't pass. Because I wouldn't have wanted to like
a little bit
make
of me, a
fucking
little bit of
totems
me
for every
still,
single
a
skill.
little bit of me still wishes it would have passed. I don't know. I guess I
I would have
was
hated it. Yeah,
looking
same.
for something else to the game.
Oh, I want to go do a Slayer task. I better make my Slayer totem first. It's like, fuck off, mate. I don't want to make no Slayer totem. I just want to go do Slayer and kill shit, alright? Slayer totem.
Right, what are your guys' thoughts on the OS Buddy Orion client, and what would you like to see future updates on in it? I think it's the best client. It is really OP. I don't really think that people should be. I mean, if you're not using it, you are choosing to put yourself at a disadvantage. And there's really no reason not to use it other than like
Kind of like
morals.
Nightmares on Guthans and alts and stuff like
It's a client. You
that.
really think you could compare the two? You're an idiot.
It's an unfair advantage.
Well, if you use the argument that you're choosing not to use it, then yeah, you
Yeah,
could
it's the same
compare
thing.
them.
You cannot compare the two.
Because we are choosing not to
It's
use
about
six
choice.
hour AFK method.
They're both allowed, and you're choosing not to do it.
There's playing the game, and there's not playing the game. You can't compare the
It's
two.
allowed though. It's allowed though.
But OS Buddy makes a lot of things take a lot less time.
That's true. Like
True.
farming. You're not like physically running to a farming patch to see it's diseased. You just know it's diseased by
Or popping
seeing
worlds. Yeah,
it.
but only noobs check diseased patches
I
anyway.
don't personally do that either, but
Yeah.
still, just an example.
And
Well, go
if you
figure
know
what
how
off-track you're on.
farming ticks work, you don't really need the farming tool.
People use it to, actually heal their patches or
Yeah,
cure them.
that's
Yeah, I used to do
true.
that on my farming Iron Man. Just check it every time. But
Does it break the Iron Man rules if you use a third-party client because you didn't make it yourself? What?
Oh, exposed. Now I
Well, Ador,
lose
not an
my
Iron
icon.
Man.
Damn it.
I use OS Buddy. I think a lot of things are way too OP. Like a couple of years ago, I don't think Jagex would have put up with this shit. Like wood copying, like if in actual 2007, I don't think Jagex would have allowed that shit for a second. A third-party
Never.
software quick copying. They just let it go through because Jackmob works for Jagex.
Fantastic client. A future update I would want to see in it, I guess, would be, I guess, open source, I believe is the correct
No,
term. I
that'd be such a bad idea.
why?
Because people just make botting clients out of it.
I mean, from the fact, like, if I waited forever for there to be a Pyramid Plunder timer, we waited forever for there to be a Magic Imbue timer. If Matt wasn't so damn lazy and spent 10 fucking minutes, he could make that timer.
There's a Magic Imbue timer.
Yeah.
There is, yeah.
That's what I'm like, do you know how long we had to wait for that? Do you know how long we had to wait for a Pyramid
Think
Plunder
about
timer?
all of the overpowered stuff that's already on Orion. If every fucker could just start actually making their own plugins,
that all have to get checked, that all have to get through, and how much of stuff would get through that's overpowered. I think that'd be so bad. I mean, it'd be a good idea, but so much overpowered stuff and broken stuff would come through.
They don't do enough work, and there's plenty of genius people out there who could provide a lot of help and useful plugins.
Like, if genius
game.
People out there could make it into a bot as well.
Yup, ain't. Oh, well.
But I don't like how, like, always buddy, get, like, with quick hopping, like, dark chest became, like, one of the most efficient way to train thieving.
The
most, okay.
This is kind of stupid, though, that's
yeah.
the thing.
Dark chest were fantastic.
I think that's the only, I don't know, the only downside about Orion. Orion's a great client. But I think the quick hopping kind of, like, changed skilling in RuneScape just for thieving. I've never done dual chests myself, so, you know, I don't really know much about them. But yeah, they are currently the best XP in the game. But other than that, Orion's a fantastic client. I love using it. I hate when it goes down when there's an update or something. I just feel like a peasant playing on, like, a really tiny screen that old school have. I really want resizable in the game. Get on that.
It's coming.
Also, worth noting that about 40% of the people playing old school right now are using OS Buddy.
Nah, it's definitely more than that.
Isn't it like 80%?
15,000 on OS Buddy, 22,000 on
it's
everything else.
17 on OS Buddy and 26,000 online.
How many of those people are free?
No, the 22,000... Is that everybody playing or everybody not using OS Buddy?
That's everyone playing, including
everyone.
The OS Buddy users.
Oh, so it's, yeah, like 70% using
OS
Buddy.
Early mornings, it's like 95% or something. There's like 10k online and
Confirmed 9.5k
OS Buddy users.
It really does get real high with the ratio of users at some points.
I use OS Buddy and, well, it is OP. And if JGX would make their own client, which would show XP drops and XP rates for skills,
the only reason
then,
they use it is the XP rates.
Yeah,
that's so good.
But I'd probably still use OS Buddy Pro for Slayer and Wyverns just to see the drops on ground. But
OS Buddy is it's one of those things that if you don't use it,
you're
at such a disadvantage.
I'd be all for banning OS Buddy if they just made XP drops and XP tracker on JGX client.
That's not they don't want to put any effort towards doing that though.
Yeah, and but
OS Buddy actually holds back the actual game quite a lot, because if OS Buddy didn't exist, we'd probably have a lot more people asking for XP drops. But since we've pretty much got them already, they just no one asks for it. So I think we would already have them if OS Buddy wasn't around.
Although it's kind of good thing, because then the old school team doesn't have to spend dev time creating.
Yeah, they can spend more time making dank memes and
innit. Okay.
Yeah, Quick Up also made Iron Man a lot more easier for buying stuff. Like buying supplies, battle staffs, and charter
shops. You
got an
Iron Man if you use OS Buddy? Confirmed.
Yeah.
I'm joking, by the way.
Not me.
All right, let's talk about bot.
I was gonna say
okay, fine, go.
Oh, the XP drops in RS3, with, like the little circle that tells you how far you're into your skill and everything. Those are really slick and really nice. A lot better than OS Buddies.
Yeah.
Saying.
They're not gonna put forth the effort into it if they know the majority of players already have it and use it. But alright, let's talk about some bots. Do you guys think all bots are necessarily bad? If not,
yes.
Elaborate on it.
Alright, straight up, no. Not all bots are bad. Mainly the ones that gather lots of resources and bring bulk resources into the game are quote-unquote good bots. They help out like things like the herb market, stuff like that. They really make banking those buybles a lot easier. A while ago, it was like maybe 10 months ago now, when they banned a whole lot of bots, we really saw like the RuneScape economy tank hard, and it was just like it was hard to buy raw sharks, it was hard to buy herbs, all those kind of resources were incredibly hard to buy. So straight up, no, not all bots are bad.
Yes, all bots are bad. God damn it, Case. Because if there wasn't any bots, then getting like herb supplies would be worth it for noobs as a money-making skill.
Exactly, mate.
And there would still be resources on the market just because everyone would do it for the profits. So yeah, ban all bots. Fuck them.
I'm kind of agreeing with Case here because I remember when all bots got banned, and like in Hex's clan chat, everyone was like, "Where am I gonna get all these supplies from?" Like, yeah, a lot of supplies were gone. But now that Jagex is actually doing a great, well, John C is actually doing a great job with the drop tables. Like, I don't think that bots are necessary now for supplies. Supplies wise,
I think they still are, to be honest.
yeah, for things like herbs and stuff, but yeah.
But if you ban bots, you gotta ban like 40% of the player base, right?
True. Less
Yep. Do it for the
subscribers.
Nightmare Zone and everything and splashing.
Do it. Do it.
I don't think all bots are bad. Those resource bots supply, I mean, really, like, we need them in the game. And I don't know, I think there are a lot of good bots that bring in like herb supplies, bots that bring in magic logs, bots that bring in battle staves, air orbs, other things like this, seeds. I think bots like that are good because they're really, it all just comes down to there are not enough people bringing in resources for the rest of the player base.
Yeah, but then it would be efficient to get them yourself if there wasn't anyone to get them for you.
Exactly, mate. I think one thing they are planning and probably will do is when the snake boss comes out, it'll drop a shit ton of resources, which will be very
Yeah, I
nice.
was talking to John C about the drop table. I sent him a list of things that I thought should be included on it, and he said most of those will probably be on it. It'll be a little bit similar to how the Wyvern drop table is, but there'll be a few other things added in there to
What was on your
Wyvern drop
list?
table is so fucking broken, dude.
No, don't fix it yet.
No, like things on the
Like,
list that
I
I
need to
see.
kill
It's
50k of them.
similar. If Wyverns are similar to the snake boss, for example, and you like the snake boss is a boss. And the wyverns are
I think you're taking what I'm
wyverns.
saying way too literally.
It will
Probably.
be in way
Probably.
bigger quantities, probably.
Yeah.
The snake boss better be dropping like a
You'll
hundred
make
battle staffs and
you'll
shit,
make a lot
mate.
more money off of the snake boss, but it's gonna be things like Addy bars, battle staffs, rune bars, alkables. The drop table is gonna be real similar.
Magic seeds.
Yeah, high level seeds and stuff like that. The drop.
They should put in more
Spikes.
herbs, though.
Yeah, there's gonna be
Spikes,
herbs as
herbs.
well.
Like
For herb seeds,
twenty
because people don't
times.
bot. People don't bot like farming, I don't
Yeah,
think.
but it wouldn't
The
hurt,
herb
like.
seeds are better than herbs.
It wouldn't hurt though if they would, if the boss would drop, like a 20 note, of one herb.
Yeah, that'd be real nice. The drop table's gonna be pretty similar to Wyverns though, and that if you're not gonna get a big drop, you're gonna get a pretty solid mid-tier drop, like an alkabul or something like that, like Addy
Or
bars.
consistent money.
Yeah.
All right.
Are you supposed to hybrid the boss?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. I want to do it, but I need to get my range up then.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Or magic, you don't know yet.
Oh, yeah, good point.
I think melee and range will probably be the two best methods of killing it, though.
Cracking your
Unle
skill.
unless it's weak to magic or something.
Well, yeah, I
Yeah,
mean, the.
the trident's really efficient magic. Don't
Trident's.
need to wear like all that magic gear. You can just throw it on with like full bandos and it hits just as fine.
Yeah, true.
I guess there's, yeah.
Buying full bandos.
Buying full bandos.
Okay, do you guys think alternate accounts will eventually ruin the economy?
I personally don't think that like alt accounts, I thought you said that three of the players on the top page use alts.
Yeah.
Way more than that.
No, three of the top 20.
Three of the top 20,
That
then
better be including Link's
yeah,
Guild.
I'm looking at EHP when I say that.
I'm fairly sure most Slaystar top pages have alts.
I'm looking at
Well,
EHP.
I don't think that, like only the elitist players actually use alts efficiently, but I don't think that will ruin the economy because it's only like maybe a 50 players that use it like efficiently to make a lot of money, but I don't think that has an effect on the 22K. How many people that play this game? 60K? Like weekly?
Jagex throws around numbers that they don't even know.
Yeah, not let's say 50K like weekly, and yeah, I don't think that will ruin the account if it's just 50 to 100 people who use it efficiently.
Yeah, I agree. They won't ruin the economy, but they ruin the competition.
Yeah.
It won't ruin the economy. It depends what kind of alt it is, honestly, like a Naturune alt. Nats are already in a bad condition, so that wouldn't help. But something like a Wyvern or something like that, like you can't get enough like raw supplies in the game, so that's not really a problem. Depends on which one, really.
Got to agree with you on the part that a Wyvern account helps the economy actually for all of the supplies that it brings in.
Yeah, Wyvern Arts are, I mean, I buy a lot of supplies. I'm not gonna name any names, but I have friends who have alts, and I buy all their Wyvern supplies from them. Though I'm against alts, it's still really good to buy it. I think alts, with a GE, having an alt with, like, six more offer tables to
Oh,
merch
that would
on
be
would be more OP.
huge. That would be
More OP
huge.
than having a Wyvern alt, and that would ruin the economy more so than adding resources.
That's a fair point.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, it's a good point that you make there. I didn't think about it that way. But I don't think they ruin the economy. I think they help it a little bit. So things like doing battle styles for crafting wasn't really a viable option prior to the Wyvern drop table update. But now, because of it, battle staffs have become a viable option for crafting, so it's helped it in that way, and it hasn't really ruined the economy.
Also, adamant bars, eddy
Yeah, that
plates.
too, yeah.
Wyverns have a lot to offer, and I think that people who use an alt to kill wyverns are helping the economy out more than they are hurting it.
Plus
Yeah,
one. Whatever you say.
Well, you've been there, Adam, so.
Yep.
All right, Jeet says, I understand why people after they max train easy skills for like 200 mil, like thieving, cooking, shit like that. But for those of us who are maxed, why don't we train any long, hard skills?
The voice leader has a great point here. I've wondered the same. Like, why does everyone go for the fast XP? Personally, I've always liked to do the slow skills, grindy ones. And if I ever max this Iron Man account, I'll probably go for construction, which is really slow, doing DIY stuff.
It doesn't really matter. I mean, eventually all the people with 200 mil thieving and cooking and crafting and smithing are gonna have to man up and do woodcutting or something. So it doesn't really matter what order you do them in. In fact, it's inefficient to do cooking because you could get cooking from fishing. And it's actually inefficient to even max before doing 200 mil fishing. So
Yep.
I don't know. Order doesn't really matter too much.
Yeah, pretty much what Tran said. Like, I personally only train fast skills for the incentive of getting ranks. Like, otherwise I'd just be straight up doing Slayer, but even Slayer's pretty fast to be fair. It's like 200k overall XP an hour, but yeah, most people just do it for ranks, to be honest.
But you'll
Yeah,
get
I think it... Yeah, go
good
ahead.
EHP ranks doing the
Also,
slow
but you
skills.
take good EHP ranks and good overall ranks if you're the last ones.
Fuck the overall rank.
Yeah,
And I'm rank 3 Iron Man.
those guys who have like higher overall rank than EHP rank really fucking suck, dude.
Yep.
A.
Yeah. I think it just comes down to
Yeah,
like
Adam.
the type of player that you are, like the type of skiller that you are. Like if you're a competitive skiller, you're going to want to gain ranks and be competitive in that sense and do the fast XP as quick as you can to gain ranks as quick as you can. Whereas if you sort of just want to max and then do all the skills you enjoy, then you'll do the slower skills. You know, if you enjoy agility or fishing or something, you'll do those skills. So it just comes down to the type of skiller that you are, really.
Yeah, basically what Kay said, it's just however you enjoy the game. If you like a lot of XP, you just gain a lot of XP. If you like Lador, you just do all the slow ones. Personally, I like mixing it up for all the skills, but yeah, it's just who you are really.
I like seeing big numbers as well.
You like big things, huh?
Yeah.
For me, I enjoyed doing both Pyramid Plunder and Dorg chests. It was genuinely fun for me. Cooking is just laid back as fuck. I don't know. I guess I, as Adam said, like you want that incentive to get those overall ranks. And eventually you're gonna have to get it done. I don't know. I don't have a good answer for this. I've had a lot of really bad answers today.
We still love you, though.
right. What is the key to grinding out skills?
There's not really an answer to that, like, to be honest. You can either have motivation or discipline. Discipline, you'll just man up and do it anyway, even though you're not enjoying it. Or motivation, you're gonna do it because you want to do it and you actually enjoy it. But I don't know, you've got to have one or the other. Like, well, I just sort of like playing, so I don't really know how to answer that, to be honest.
Having autism helps.
Confirm.
Shots fired.
But being in a clan where they notice that you're doing well helps, I don't know.
I think the key to grinding is just having fun, really. Don't make it feel like a job for yourself. I mean, you're coming on to have fun. You're not obligated to do anything. Just have fun. And if what is having fun to you is getting XP, then go ahead and do that. It's not like that for everybody. But for some people, just the key to grinding is just by having fun, and by having fun, they're getting XP.
The key to grinding is reindeer piss. And polar bear piss.
And Kinku.
And Kinku.
Three
but
weapons and
yeah,
spoons.
yeah, I agree with Randy. It's just what we like to do. I love the grind. I love repetitive. Blah, 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 blah. Can't say the word. Like doing the same thing all over, over and over again. And it's just what I enjoy doing. And yeah, go on.
It's basically, yeah, what everyone said. I can say yes, yeah, it's a lot of fun. But I have seen a video about grinding and how it's mentally achieved by Acid Soul, and you
Great
should
video.
definitely check that out.
Oh, Acid
You should
Soul.
definitely check that out if you want to like get a deeper view into grinding.
Yeah, Randy,
You
link it
can, yeah,
all
in the
right. I'll write
description.
that
Yeah,
down.
put
We're
it
at
in the
1 minute
description.
and 40 seconds in.
1 minute 40
Yeah.
seconds.
1 hour, 1 minute.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I told you, I'm off today. I am off.
145k magic seeds.
All right. Sorry.
All right. So I think there are two key aspects to grinding out skills. I think the first one is to have a love for the game or a love for what you're doing. And the second one is a competitive drive. a lot of like achievements and, you know, pulling like 120 hour weeks come from having a competitive drive. And a clan like Hexus, we're all pretty competitive people, but at the same time we're pretty laid back people as well, so being around like-minded and motivated people can really help with the grind and achieving the things you want to achieve, really.
Yeah, it's also the support from friends really helps.
Yeah, definitely agree with that one.
Yeah, if I wasn't in Hexus, I definitely wouldn't be playing as much, wouldn't be enjoying myself as much. So I think that has a lot to do with it as well.
Yeah.
I was a total noob before I joined Hexus. I cut willows for wood cutting and maple longs for 90 fletching or something.
It's weird to think that because you're such a good skiller. Like, you're yep. You are very efficient and very good at what you do, man.
So. Yeah, but I've always liked skilling, and I've always wanted to be a good skiller, but I didn't have like the tools, or I didn't know the people who could teach me. And when I got those, then my potential was freed or something.
Untapped potential.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Alright, what is your guys' view on ultimate Iron Man accounts and the micro efficiency skilling on these accounts, and would you ever consider making one for yourself?
I had an ultimate Iron Man, but I don't know, I played it for like 10 hours maybe, and I didn't enjoy it at all. Like, I'm so used to having a bank, and I couldn't imagine the pain that people have to go through to even, like, if they die, you just lose everything. Like, I don't know how the people do it, like the top ranks in Ultimate Iron Man, but it's definitely props on people who actually manage to, get high levels and overall.
Agreed. I could never do Ultimate Iron Man. It just feels too hard, and you need to have a lot of game knowledge. Well, most of us do. But, props. And about the micro efficiency, I think macro efficiency is more important on accounts like that. To actually know which methods to do and know what you're doing. And I'd never consider making one myself. Fuck that. Even normal Iron Man is hard enough.
Yeah, I think what some people have done on them is something I wouldn't have the discipline to do. There's no way I would even enjoy playing that way. But I'm really impressed by what some people have been able to do without banking. I saw there's a dude who has a DFS and Ranger boots on an Ultimate Iron Man. I know that's luck based, but it's still pretty impressive. I wouldn't enjoy playing so restricted, and I would never consider making one for myself.
I probably just wouldn't enjoy not having a bank. That'd be so fucking, like, one of the things I love about, I don't know, RuneScape is seeing items build up in your bank. I love seeing huge stacks of things. I don't know why. Like drop tabs and stuff like that.
I'm the same way.
Looks awesome. I could, but you'd have a, I don't know. What do you call an Iron Man who just made bank? Made inventory? Fuck. Yeah, I wouldn't like to do that. That was the cheesiest joke ever, but yeah.
Whatever. It was pretty bad.
My view on those accounts, some of the people that play those accounts have got a lot of motivation and a lot of discipline. I personally would never make one because that's just not how I enjoy playing the game. I enjoy playing the game how I played it 10 years ago, and that's, you know, with a bank, with barely any restrictions. With the micro-efficiency side of the thing, I think what Lelador said before about macro-efficiency being more important, just because the playstyle of the account is a lot different, and macro efficiency will help you more in the long run. Yeah, that's my view on those accounts.
I can't imagine not having a bank. It just seems weird. I don't even know why it's like a game mode. I think hardcore, I mean, to make more sense, but Because of that, if anybody ever does 200 mil agility, they will officially be better than Bradford Lee.
True that.
Wanted to say that, yep.
Yeah, Brad only got 200 mil agility because he took donations anyway.
Yep.
And he used the bank.
Yep.
Yep. He wouldn't have done it without the profit.
Exactly.
All right, Dreamland asks, what is your favorite CML donator icon? But the one that I do genuinely like the best is Magic Box. He, his picture is a fucking magic box. I don't know, that's cool to me. No, 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 I take that back, I take that back. Trance's piss bottle is the best, by far. That piss bottle is the best one on CML, hands down.
Shout out to Foot for actually drawing that.
I would have to go for Kakari because of the Legend of Zelda.
Oh, I thought that was like an Illuminati thing that he had.
Nah, mate.
I thought it was a triangle with like an eye.
What's everything, the name?
Everything's about Illuminati these days.
Yeah. I think my favorite CML donator icon is Football, or previously known as Goku. His little Goku icon there. I just love the Goku. That's what I grew up with. Dragon Ball Z was awesome, so I think that's the best donator icon.
Is it me? Oh.
Yeah.
My bad. I prefer them simple, and I love pink, so I have to say E-Fire, Harmony, and some other guy had a pink crown.
Jane.
So
Jane.
I like those. Yeah. Those ones.
Without a doubt, hands down, the most amazing and creative CML icon, without, like, you can't even deny this, is Bayor's upside down pink crown. That is gold.
That one's great too.
And it's pink.
Amazing. Yep.
Love it.
Trance, who was your favorite?
My own.
Oh, that's what I like to hear. Hey, it is the best one, the fucking piss bottle. I think that Slayer Lamp has a cool one as well, just because of it kind of matching his name. I want to also give a shout out to Tails. His is nice.
With Tails itself, yeah.
What is Renz's icon?
It's
I can't make out
first,
what that is.
First prestige on Call of Duty Black Ops.
Oh, really? Oh, dear.
Yeah. First prestige max. Let's
oh,
go.
Yeah. And Sphinx's is cool with the Sphinx, I guess. I think Dreary's is kind of funny in a sense that when he changed his to that, he No, the League of Legends one, that he went to go play League of Legends at that point in time. I don't think it's as good anymore. All right. What amount of time not paying attention would you consider being AFK? The person asking says if you look away from the PC even for a second, it would be considered AFK.
I feel like this question is kind of a troll question, but I'll answer it seriously anyway. I don't think looking away from the screen is considered AFK, because you know we all do it. We all watch movies on the side. We, you know, browse the internet, rah rah rah. So I think where I would draw the line is something like Nightmare Zone Guffins. You are literally in bed, asleep, not at your computer. That is definitely not how Jagex, Andrew Gawa, all wanted the game to be played. That's not in the spirit of the game, and. That's probably where I draw the line at with being AFK.
Yeah, I think the term AFK to me, and I think most people, is like a scale at which you rate the
click intensity.
The click intensity of an activity. So like wines, even though you have to click every 20 seconds or whatever, they're still AFK, like a 7 on the scale. Whereas granite and what three tick fishing is like a 9. So on the AFK scale, mines would be like a 7, and then granite would be like a 1, I guess. I don't know.
Well, if you look at the term AFK self, it basically means away from keyboard, but like, yeah, stuff like taking a piss.
We never leave our keyboard, so.
No, I mean like looking away from the screen, you're still at your keyboard, but I mean if you're going to take a piss, that's not really AFK either, because you're going to be back in less than a minute. And like if you're going to make a sandwich or something, then okay, log off. But yeah, same goes for splashing and Nightmares and Guthans. Just not, it shouldn't be allowed, man. Fucking
but
hell.
If you're doing Nightmares and Guthans, if you sleep with your keyboard, it count as AFK.
That's yes. My joke, motherfucker.
I like Francis' answer. Like, I use AFK as a measure of like skill intensity, as he said it. Like RC, and it's semi AFK skill, as in like cooking, pretty cooking is it's not AFK skill. And but would I consider AFK? Something you can do for like 10 or 15 seconds without clicking or doing anything on your RuneScape screen. Maybe.
I would say it depends on the skill. A lot of it with like click intensity. I mean, 4-tick cooking is pretty fucking, I mean, that's about as AFK as it gets. 5-tick fishing, extremely AFK. Same goes with wood cutting. That can also be very AFK. I have a problem with people calling Motherlode Mine AFK. It's not AFK. It's just not click intensive. You still have to pay attention to almost every single swing of your pickaxe.
Or are you just putting your sound?
Wow.
Yeah, I think it's semi AFK.
It's not. I wouldn't consider the Motherlode AFK, but I would say it's not click intensive. So I don't know. I guess it really depends on a lot of shit. Slayer, for the most part, is pretty AFK, regardless what task.
Not for me.
Besides Dags. Besides Dags, I'd say for the most part it's pretty AFK.
Dags?
Dagonoss. You gotta click your cannon and everything.
Yeah. For how often you have to click your cannon. But
that's like a 10-minute task,
yeah.
But if you do like Dark Beasts or even Dark Beasts, but Black Demons as well. I mean that it's not AFK.
Mate,
whatsoever.
I cooked pancakes.
Yeah.
During Black Demons. I mean,
I went to McDonald's during Black Demons. I'm not joking.
Like, it's just so, it's so, I don't, it really depends.
Pre-OC, I took a shower while chinning, and didn't even log out.
That's pretty ballsy.
Yeah.
Like, for fletching, cutting the logs into unstrungs is pretty AFK, but stringing them isn't.
Shout out to Cap King.
Cap King is a champ.
Yeah.
Stringing is still pretty AFK.
Pinning?
Stringing the bows.
Stringing the bows. Which is like 10
I don't know
seconds.
How AFK I would consider it. It's just not click intensive.
Well, it's as AFK as wines, I think. Isn't
it's
it?
It's exactly the same.
Yeah.
Three tick or two tick, isn't it? Three.
I think it's two. I don't know. I've never strung any bows.
Alright, what is your guys' most embarrassing moment on RuneScape?
Oh, God.
I don't think I have one. Well, the closest is probably when I tried streaming to getting my whip on my Iron Man, and I lost my boost 4 times inside 100 kills because I got distracted. That was pretty bad. And then I just rage quit and went to do agility and got the whip off stream. But apart from that, I don't think there's anything.
I've never done anything that's embarrassing in RuneScape. Apart from that one time I died to a camel.
I lost to Bodhi at RuneLink on his stream. And
that was so funny, dude. I was expecting to completely wreck him. The RuneLink champion gets
so
beaten in like
nervous.
5 seconds.
And he was like calling me out, "This guy's the champion, mate." And I was like, "Oh my god, I gotta beat him." I just blundered so hard in like turn 4. Oh, that was so embarrassing.
What the fuck is RuneLink?
Connect 4.
Oh, in the games.
Yeah.
Yeah, the games.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Okay.
That place.
That dreaded place. This is the perfect slide into Zerov's story.
Yeah, well, I fucking got lured from my bank.
Tell us about it.
Oh, well, this guy came up to me and he was like, "I got like 35 mil from this guy. You want me to teach you how to do it?" And I was like, "Yeah, okay, I don't mind a free 30 mil. So he was like getting to know me better, and he was also from my country. And
oh, was he?
He was,
Bobby,
yeah.
Said that.
Yeah, but he also he lived like 20 miles away, and he could name the school and that I also knew. And yeah, it was just getting my like trust or anything, something like that. And basically, it all came down to it all became so tempting, and I kind of trusted him. But it was all a bit fake, and then I went to Berthrope, and I'm gonna cry. No, no, I literally was almost crying then, but I had to drop all my stuff, and he was the only one there, and then he would give me 20 mil, and I was like, okay, well, I'll drop them and pick him back up, like, directly. But some other guy came and he spawned like, I don't know, like 50 euros with AHK probably. Just spam click it. And then I couldn't grab my stuff, and the other guy just dropped a staff so he could pick all the rest of the stuff up, and I lost like, I don't know, what was it, 150 mil?
Yeah, roughly that.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Well, that's what happened.
How was he able to pick it up and you weren't?
Well, he dropped
the
staff
on the ground,
then,
which you can click on.
Yeah.
Oh, because he already had, like, yeah.
Yeah.
Never trust easy money.
I know, man. it's kind of late for the for
teaching. I know, Captain Hindsight.
Alright, I think Case is Case's turn.
Yeah, I don't really have an embarrassing moment. I can't really remember too much. Maybe when I was younger, I just got like, because I was, you know, young, naive, I got scammed a lot, you know, back when, like, you know, 2006, 2007, just getting scammed for items in bank and stuff. You know, at the time you have, like, a 1 mil bank, and then you just, like, get scammed for it and start crying, and, yeah, that's pretty much it for me.
I'm not sure of embarrassing moments. One thing I regret, though, back when I RuneCrafted, I was RuneCrafting with a friend of mine at the time, and I wanted to make a point to him, so I was just fucking around, and I used a wood cutting axe in the abyss a lot, and I don't know, I guess that's maybe embarrassing.
Well, to be fair, your wood cutting level was...
My wood cutting was like 25 levels higher.
Yeah.
And I was still beating him, and I guess I was just having fun using that. I don't know. But, alright, someone asks, is doing clue scrolls you get from Slayer considered efficient? I'll just take this one. No. Not at all.
Yep.
No clue scroll. Clue scrolls are not efficient. Do not ever do them. Ever.
Oh. You suck. Elite clues are worth doing.
Are they actually worth doing?
Well, I do them in like 10 minutes, and it's an average of 500k loot, so yeah.
10-minute average, my ass.
But it's not worth going out of your way to
get
them.
If you're bad at clue scrolls and like don't know where ideas, yeah, you'll probably take longer than 10 minutes.
Yeah, it like, took me like 40 minutes to do my first delete.
Once you do like 10, you've got them down, it's like, teleport here, talk to this guy, teleport here, dig this up.
Or if you have to drop your clue every other step,
yeah,
because
don't
you've
do it then.
Requirements.
If you're max, though, elites would be worth it, I think.
Elites are worth it if you do not use alternate accounts to make money. If you do, they are not worth it.
Yeah, yeah.
I did hard clues on my Iron Man.
Oh, they're definitely worth it on Iron Man.
No, not really. At first, yeah, because you get a lot of alcohols and you need money. But after a while, you start getting a lot more cash from the
players.
Tasks. And later, when you do the Wyverns, you have like 400 mil cash.
I'd probably do it for the swag items, mate.
We'll just get the Black Dragon hide and get out.
I'll get a pirate hat.
But I'm not doing them anymore. Well, I still do them every now and then, maybe one a day. And I do all the medium clues in case I get Samurak pages.
Alright. What do you guys think is the best skill to get 99 in first? And what do you think is the, what would be the best one to get last?
Blackjack. To 90, no, yeah, blackjack to 91 thieving, and then buy 2 animal fishing and feathers, and yeah, you should start your account.
Have fun.
I'm not joking. That would be the most efficient way to do it.
Yeah,
blackjack to 91, and you can buy all the feathers you need for 2 animal fishing.
And I think we all agree on this: the best skill to do last is Slayer.
Yeah, I agree.
Yep.
Why Slayer?
Because Slayer always gets updated.
Oh, true. But if I ever did max on Lila, I would have done cooking as my last 99.
Cooking's so fun, dude. You'd probably really enjoy Tutik cooking. You'd probably like it.
I tried Tutik cooking and it was too hard.
Yeah, I've only done it for like for like 2 inventories. It's
I only practiced for 5 minutes and I was tired, so I gave up.
Nothing is too hard for Lila.
A few hours actually doing 2-tick cooking. Yeah, just 2.5 tick. It's fucking easier. It's like, I don't know, only a bit less XP.
All right, if you guys could go back to the release of Old School, what would you do differently this time around?
That on time, not start like a month late, and probably get into skilling a bit faster, because it took me like 6 months to actually, you know, start skilling. I was just dicking around killing cave horrors and stuff at the start.
I'd be a lot more efficient from the start. I joined Hexes in September, so I started being efficient 7 months late. And I'd probably raise Jebrim to max.
Ooh.
Oh, mate, I would have fucking wrecked Jeb. Oh, no, I had college, fuck. I would have left college and shit in it.
It would have been fun to give Jebrim some competition. I think if I was as good as I am now back then, I would have actually given him good competition. It would have been really fun. I'm sure a lot of people feel that way, too.
Yeah.
I feel this. I probably wouldn't have been able to do it unless I dropped out of college.
For me, I wouldn't have dicked around for the first month. I was just doing a lot of stuff with some of my friends who, you know, there's like 10 of us or so who got all back into the game. And I was just messing around with them as well. And it just, I guess I wasn't efficient whatsoever. Wasn't really enjoying the game either, because I ultimately started skilling because I was broke as fuck and I wanted some money. The only thing I would redo would be my first month of RuneScape.
I think for me, what I would do is, I think I'd make a lot more investments in future potential updates. I know this is kind of hindsight talking, but at the beginning of RuneScape, you know, there were things that you could tell were going to be released eventually. Things like the Zamorak Spear, things like that, for when, like, Corporal Beast and, like Torstal Seeds as well, like the possibility of them releasing like an overload or a potion similar to that as well. I think I just would have like thought through about wise investments to make earlier in the game and then made bank off those.
The same, like, I've been so close to merching that shit, and then
Yeah,
I just
same.
pussy out, like, instead of
Yeah.
doing it. I'm like, yeah, but what if it goes wrong? And I just don't do it. But every single
Yeah.
time I've thought about doing it, I should have done it. So I should
Yeah,
just
you're
start,
being
like,
correct.
actually, doing stuff like that.
Yeah, like the new continent, like you could think about things that are potentially going to rise or they're going to introduce into the game and then make investments on that.
Or if they nerf Nightmare Zone, PRS would go up.
Yeah.
But oh, is there a question about Matt K saying they should have removed Nightmare Zone?
We can
And
talk about that at the end.
now, since I just brought it up.
Fuck it, go into it then.
Yeah, on the 2014 retrospective stream or whatever, Matt K said their biggest mistake was not fixing Nightmare Zone earlier on. And he
Yep,
was like,
well,
it's already a part of the game now, we can't change it.
you fucking can just do it.
Yeah, like it's never too it's to keep getting worse and worse and worse.
They did it with the magic, like they didn't
Yeah,
pull
you
that,
click
did they? And
splashing.
then yeah, and like but no, they're talking about the Nightmare Zone magic as well, where you could get free runes inside Nightmare Zone. So you did that without, you know, pulling it. So why not just do the whole thing?
If an item duplication glitch was in the game for a year, would it be just part of the game? Nope.
Probably.
Well, to be fair, at that point, I don't know, the game would probably be dead.
Be quite dead at that point for sure.
But they should just say that the whole Nightmare Zone thing was a bug and we are gonna remove it.
Nightmare Zone in general was just a bug, it just appeared by accident.
Right, so moving on. What is your favorite looking Slayer monster?
Boy, I've never thought about that, to be
That's a
honest.
good question.
Probably, the cave bug.
Why?
What even is that? Well, it doesn't get enough love, man. I just gotta appreciate the cave bug. Like, we all take them for granted, and they just don't get any attention. We should buff cave bugs, to be
Yeah,
honest.
buff that drop table.
Dropping some battle staffs, maybe.
I would say I really like the crawling hands and the jellies. Those would probably be my thing. I don't really have any reason why. I guess the no reason. I suck. Crawling hands and jellies.
I think all right, I just lost my idea. What did I have? I think the Smoke Devil was pretty good. Smoke Devil graphically looks pretty well done. And the cave it's in as well is pretty good. Yeah, crawling hands are pretty cool as well. I agree with Randy on that one as well.
I'm gonna go with Killer Watts.
Ooh. Yeah, and I'm gonna go with Turoths because just there are like three different three different, how do you say that?
They're a weird looking creature.
PCs. Yeah, they're, I don't know, I kinda like them.
At first when I saw this question I had no idea, but after I read it I saw a post in Reddit about a close up on a black demon, and it looked horrible, so I have to pick the black demon.
A Slayer monster, though.
Sorry?
Player task.
No, Slayer monster. It's not on the Slayer ta like monster list.
Oh, is it not?
Nice. You don't need a Slayer level
Task,
to
but it's
kill them.
oh, then Bloodweld, or is it not?
Yeah, Bloodveld. Yeah.
Okay, then it. I like the tongue.
Nice.
Moving on. What is your guys' opinion on the mods hiding splashing, like in PvP worlds and other shit like this, after they said that, after they said making splashing. Alright, so when they were talking about adding stuff to the new continent, mod Matt K said, well, we can't add magic shit in there if people are splashing away to 99. I don't know, he said something like that.
Yeah, he said it would make like high level magic content, sort of like dead content and redundant.
Yeah.
So what's the question?
What is your opinion on them hiding it?
What's your opinion on them hiding splashing and PvP worlds?
Well, their argument is, oh, you're risking a lot.
If you remember on the live stream after they nerfed splashing, Matt Kay said, we are getting rid of splashing because it will make it hard for mod reach to make any magic content because everyone would have already finished it by the time the content comes out. So why say that and not fix it and hide it? You didn't fix the problem, that's still a problem. Like, mod reach, nothing for him has changed. It's still going to be a problem, so that's either bullshit or you are, I don't know, blind.
Mod Archie even mentioned that the splashing is still doable in PvP worlds on his vid that he made about the splashing.
Nice.
Yep.
I think that they're just handling everything completely wrong, and they need to address the problem, not try to hide it. There are plenty of people who are splashing on things in banks. Like, if you go into Lumbridge basement right now, you'll probably find someone splashing on a spider standing at the little rewards chest there. They don't get randoms. It doesn't stop them. And you can find someone doing it there. You can find someone doing it in Trinome Village or Trinome Stronghold at Neve's Bank. People are able to do it everywhere, not even just in PvP worlds.
I'm actually at the Neve Bank at the moment, and there isn't anyone splashing on the Gnome Guard. This is the first time ever.
Wow.
That's rare.
I don't believe you.
Telling the world.
I hate how also they keep saying that, it's always been a part of the game. It's just never been viable until we removed randoms. Like, yeah, sounds like a cop-out, really. Like, if you can train your magic level, once again, like, while you're not at your computer, while you're sleeping, it's really not in the spirit of the game and not how it was intended to be played.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like they misunderstand the question if they say it's always been in the game. Like, yeah, obviously they should remove splashing. You should splash if you have too high or too low of a magic attack, but you shouldn't be able to stay logged in for 6 hours.
Yeah, exactly.
They should just log out timer. Yeah, they should just add in the 5-minute logout timer for everything.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah, that'd be the easiest solution.
Alright, what do you think the community should do to try to get JMod's attention against all of this splashing and 6-hour AFKing?
I've honestly given up ranting about it. I spent pretty much a solid, 3 months complaining. Not gonna change. JMods have made that pretty clear. They tried to fix it and on purpose didn't fix it. So, yeah. Fuck it. They're not gonna listen.
Yep. I mean, I know Randy and Adam and a bunch of other people chipped into a big document. What was it, the Integrity?
Yes.
Called, Randy?
The,
Called the Integrity what?
It was like pretty much describing how big of a problem it really is, and I am pretty much telling them how they're wrong and everything that they're saying. The title of it is Game Integrity, The Problems and the Solution. Yeah. And it was a fantastic...
They just ignored it.
It was a fantastic...
And ignored Randy and Adam.
Fantastic document that was written, and I believe it should be implemented into the game, really. I'm not sure what we can do to try to get their attention, because I've tried. I've spent hours and hours trying. Made that document that went into great depths into how bad of an impact it had on the game, and explaining how they were really clueless about how detrimental of an effect it actually has on the game.
I think they already, they're fully aware of the problem. I don't think they don't address it.
They don't like being wrong. They don't like being wrong either.
Yeah.
I feel like they rarely admit, hey, we made a mistake.
I know my Matt K won't admit to his mistakes.
No, yeah. they've already said that. They wish that this thing was fixed ages ago, but the reason they aren't fixing it is because they've been backed up into a corner by the fucking polls, pretty much. That's why they shouldn't poll everything, and we should just... Game integrity problems, which they have actually said before, will be fixed without a poll. And they know this affects the game's integrity. They've already said that it's a mistake, and we wish we fixed it ages ago. So why are they not, like, you know, sticking to the... It's a game integrity problem. Why don't we just fix it? I don't get that.
Yeah.
They need to have a new face coming in to the team to kind of help enlighten them on the problems.
Mod Hexis, please.
Well, you live in the UK, Adam.
Yeah, but like I'm a lazy fuck, so.
Cool. I would love to be this new QA that they have coming up, but I'm not gonna get hired. I'm not even gonna get looked at because I don't live in England. But I think.
Do you feel like you'd enjoy?
I would thoroughly enjoy it. You know what? Fuck it. I would do it for like half the price of. Really? Yeah. It wouldn't even be work to me.
Probably less than minimum wage, man.
You're not even working. You're just playing the fucking game. Like, I mean, you're paying me to play the game and talk about
it. To be fair, I don't think Mod Matt K plays the game, so he's not getting paid to play the game.
Would you still play in your main account? Because John C. basically quit.
I would still play at least 40 to 50 hours a week. I mean, I'm able to do that with school and work. And fuck else am I going to do in my free time? I mean, nothing would change with that. I'd still play 40, 50 hours.
Yeah, but you might not enjoy it as much because, like, it's one thing playing the game and enjoying it, but when you pretty much spend your entire day working on, you know, RuneScape at work and then going home to play it, you'd probably be like, ugh.
Meh.
I don't believe I would be like that. I think I would really enjoy it and keep playing just as much as I do. But
what about being with that actual team of people?
I would work well with them because of how drastically, I don't know what the word, my viewpoints are so different from theirs, and I have so much more passion that I don't think they would clash well at all.
There's a fine line between passion and crazy.
But I feel like whoever they hire, I hope can step in there and try to turn this around.
Junior QA tester who's on an internship isn't really going to have much of a say.
I really think that when they brought John C. to the team, that was like a very good decision of them because he was a high-ranked player, also ex-member of Hexes, and he knows about all the high-tier stuff and all the efficient ways and about the market and all that kind of stuff. So I hope the new guy is going to be...
I hope the new guy knows the game, not just casually plays it, but knows
it. Left the game.
What's that?
Maybe it's user.
Nah.
Oh my god.
You quit the game.
Exposed.
The hiring process isn't over until like the second week of January.
That's what they say, though.
I hope they make the right decision with this new guy. I really wish they would have opened it up to people who lived outside. Shit, I genuinely would probably almost do it for free if I didn't have to pay for living expenses. Just go in there 40 hours a week and try to work on improving the game.
I'd do it, but it's XP waste.
Like,
so.
I would do Mod Matt K and Ronan's job for free.
You would do Mod Matt K? Ooh, damn.
I would do their jobs for free just because.
Ooh, you'd do Mod Matt K's job? Ooh,
for
damn.
For free, I would. Alright, Jicklin asks, what is your favorite Twitch emote and why?
Ooh, I think mine would have to be that. It was like, I think it was like a cross between the Forever Alone face and like a Bible Thump face. Like, It was more the Forever Alone face where he's like crying and it's all like ugly and shit. I reckon that's a pretty funny one.
I have no idea.
EJ Salt.
EJ Salt's pretty good.
It's just like, it's funny because someone's salty and you spam PJ Salt and they get even
makes
more
them
saltier.
More salty.
Yeah, it's just so
good. So good.
Oh, God.
I think my favorite Twitch emote hands down is Kevin Turtle.
What does that one look like?
Black
the black dude.
He's
Texas Randy, no space.
I kind of like Adam's disconnect emote.
Oh,
every
mate,
time,
sick DC.
Oh yeah, sick DC.
Every time someone like, I remember when Buddy was disconnecting like a moron, like every other second, everyone was spamming that one. At least your subscribers, of course. But
fucking was, right, mate.
Yeah, was real fun.
My favorite one is the Kappa. Every time I see it, I just chuckle a little bit. I like.
Wow, such an obvious pick, man. It's overused, but people just use Kappa in front of everything. Like I had a guy asking my stats once and said Kappa at the end. It's like,
I think it's a funny face. I don't.
Kappa reminds me of Jiklim. I don't know why.
Excluding the sub emotes, my favorite is, I don't know what it's called, but you type ATWW and lowercase t. I can post it on the...
What is it?
TS I'm gonna have a look at this now.
But I like it because it's cute.
Plus Screamer. Oh, never even seen that ever, to
yeah,
be honest.
No
one. I've never seen that one either. Shit.
What?
Have you seen it before?
Oh, actually, to be fair, the RuneScape channel's got a pretty sick sub emote of Matt K. Amazing. Might sub to the RuneScape channel just for the Matt K emote. So good.
Shit.
Say data on it? Is it mod data?
No, it's just, I think it's just RuneScape Matt K or something.
Alright. Lalador is Finland the most successful RuneScape country?
Well, it's impossible to say, but I'd like to say yes, because I'm Finnish. But, there are a lot of efficient players from Finland. You can't argue with that. But I don't know about the most successful.
I think on a, it's like a hard thing to measure, like, in America. Like,
yeah,
it's, like, in a, like...
How do you define
I think maybe, like, great players are much more common from Finland. Like, I don't know, I guess maybe like the great player to population ratio, you would
say. Oh, yeah.
You,
there's only 5 million.
I guess that would be one way to measure it, and you would say that Finland's the best by that.
It's the reason for this is because it's really fucking cold in Finland, and no one wants to go outside, so they play RuneScape.
Yeah, it's minus 20 degrees Celsius here right now.
Ouch.
Yep.
Wow.
Fucking freezing.
Wow. Alright. What grinds your gears? Not RuneScape related, but what grinds your gears? Like a pet peeve, even.
Alright, in real life. Ooh, pet peeves. I'm a big, like, grammar Nazi. I hate, like, when people misuse words or misspell words. Like, you are and you're. Like, when somebody uses that out of context.
Mm-hmm.
And like the different theirs. I hate when people use those in the wrong context as well. Yeah,
it's pretty
peeve.
Funny when you see somebody correcting someone with the your and do it wrong.
Yeah.
It's
and
the funniest
thing.
What grinds my gears? Probably when people like they when you're walking on the street.
Damn.
And there are like three people.
Go ahead.
There are like three people walking in front of you, and they're like blocking the street so you can't pass them, and they're walking twice as slow as you.
That is pretty annoying.
Yeah. Or when people just stand in the middle of a doorway and have a chat.
Oh yeah, that's
someone else. Yeah.
One of the things that annoys me more than anything, and it legit makes me cringe IRL, is when somebody is eating and starts talking to you Oh my god, that is so annoying.
I do that, like, all the time.
Fuck you. No, it's not so bad, like, if you're talking to someone on a TeamSpeak, but if you're in front of them and you can see all, like, flying around in their mouth and shit, and it's going all over your face, it's like, what
the
fuck?
I do that in public. And I also laugh out loud, like, when I'm eating. So the food is flying everywhere. You'd love me. Hell. Adam, you'd love me.
Oh, God. To wear a fucking umbrella when I'm speaking to you.
What grinds my gears? Was this non-RuneScape related?
Yes, like...
Finnish weather. I love the summer. I hate the snow. I hate the cold. I hate the whiteness.
Hate the polar bears.
Yeah, I hate the pink polar bears. I hate drinking reindeer piss. But the summer is awesome. I love the summer, but I hate the winter.
Aren't there a lot of mosquitoes, though, in the summer?
Yeah, but not in the city. And I never leave my home, so...
Then why do you care about the weather?
Because I need to do grocery shopping every now and then.
Not true.
Them smoke breaks too, man.
Oh yeah, and smoking in that weather. God damn it. I
yeah,
freeze my fingers every time.
Freezes. You gotta relight it and shit. Yep.
And the smoke freezes and drops on my toes.
You know what really grinds my gears? Hey, John Cena. If I'm walking in front of someone or behind them, if people aren't picking up their feet and just dragging them, like, it just makes, I don't know. I hate when people drag their feet when they walk. Just really annoys me.
I used to do that a lot when I was younger, but not anymore.
It really annoys me. I don't know why. I don't know.
It's a pretty cringy noise, I guess.
I don't like it. Alright. Do you guys play any other games other than RuneScape on a daily or weekly basis?
Not regularly, I don't play any other games. Maybe once, like, a year I'll, you know, spend an hour to play a different game, but yeah. Not very often.
I used to play a lot of DayZ and a bit of Minecraft and everything, but it's mainly just been RS since 2005 for me, really. I never had that good of a PC, and RuneScape was like the only proper game I could play, and I always stick to it, so stuck to it.
Wow.
Not really, not daily, weekly. As I said earlier in the podcast, I used to be big into Call of Duty, but RuneScape's like my main sort of passion and game right now.
Yeah, buddy.
For me, I used to play I still do play it, but up until Christmas last year, I was still playing RuneScape while playing on Xbox, like 10 to 20 hours a week. I was playing Madden. And I was in this 32-man franchise. It was online. And, we had, like, a fantasy draft and stuff. And we had been doing it for years and years and years. Some nice chomping there. But this was our fifth Madden doing it in. And the league was kind of starting to die down a little bit. And some people started getting, like, the Xbox Ones and the PS4s, and eventually the league disbanded, so I stopped playing, like, 10 to 20 hours a week, and I would say I play Xbox maybe anywhere from 0 to, like, 5 hours a week now. I still play Madden occasionally, not that much, though.
The only console I had was PlayStation 1 back in 2000. And my PC has always been a piece of shit. Can't run any other game than RuneScape, so no, I don't play any other games. Although I did play Cookie Clicker for like 2 months, if you consider that game.
Did you use AHK for it?
Yeah, of course.
I play a little bit of Hearthstone, but haven't played any since I finished cooking.
Alright.
Dude, actually, I did some while fishing. I could play Hearthstone while fishing.
Possibly. Alright, have any of you guys' wrists ever got messed up from playing so much?
My wrists, no, but my hand, my mouse
I guess
hand.
you could include wrist, hand, all in one.
Well, then, yeah, my hand starts to ache if I do something extremely click intensive. Like when I did my 30-hour prayer, I had to stretch my hand every time I teleported, like once or twice in the 2 ticks it takes. But normally, when I do something. Well, especially now I'm doing Slayer and it's click intensive when I flick my prayers, but it doesn't hurt my hand at all.
I'd say
So.
the only time for me that my hand ever was hurting was when I did do prayer. And I didn't even do, I mean, it took me like 5, 6, 7 days even. I was just lazy as hell. And this was, you couldn't AFK it. But my hands really hurt from doing that. That was, I guess, the first really super click intensive thing that I ever did on RuneScape. My hands hurt. I guess my hands have adapted now. Alright, if you guys lost an arm, would you still play RuneScape?
What kind of question is that?
If you're not cutting this out, you'd probably explain what's going on. Hell, Matt, you're right, mate. Sounds like
Oh my
a
God,
fucking
I'm
squeaky
crying.
git. Mate.
Getting this?
Is that because I fucking disconnected at you laughing or what?
Yeah.
I don't know why they're laughing.
I
I'm
only
not
started
laughing.
laughing because they started laughing.
I refuse to laugh.
Alright,
That's my
I
point.
disconnected a few minutes ago mid
I hate
podcast, and
that.
apparently it's the funniest thing.
Hey, okay.
Wait, you including this shit?
Yeah, motherfucker.
Nice. Nice. All
I'll
right,
intro
carry on.
here.
What was the question again?
If you lost an arm, would you still play RuneScape?
Which arm?
Whichever one
Never
is
mind.
least
Never mind. Never mind.
valuable.
Yeah, my answer would still be the same. No, I wouldn't quit. If I lost my mouse arm, I'd just learn to use my mouse with my left. And if I lost my left arm, I just wouldn't use mouse keys or AHK. I think everybody agrees with that answer, so moving on.
I probably wouldn't play if I lost an arm.
I'd learn to play with your feet.
Yep, become a
Or your
monkey or
face.
something then. I wouldn't play if I lost my arm. Shit.
Why not? What would you do instead?
Probably try to find a way to get my arm back. I don't know.
You're Frankenstein.
Do whatever I could to get another arm. I don't
That
know.
like an anime?
What?
Full Metal Alchemist. He
Oh
loses his arm and he devotes his life to finding his arm. That's the plot. That
Full
is the
Metal
plot.
Tyrone.
That's Full Metal Tyrone. I'm done. I'm done.
All right. Do you guys prefer Dragon Ball Z or Naruto?
Dragon Ball Z.
It's pronounced Naruto.
DBZ.
Yeah, definitely. Dragon Ball Z is awesome.
Never watched any of them.
I haven't watched
Oh.
Dragon Ball Z. I tried, but it was too OP. I liked the Dragon Ball, the prequel to Dragon Ball Z. I enjoyed that a lot. But I also haven't watched Naruto Shippuden, but I've read the manga. So I'll choose Naruto. But if I could choose the original Dragon Ball, then I'd choose it.
Last question is, what did you get for Christmas?
I got a sock and half an orange.
Where's the other half?
We had to share.
I got a few things for Christmas. Got a, like a little sandwich grill maker type thing that I can like cook chicken sandwiches, stuff like that, make like toasties and whatnot. Standard like clothing stuff as well. That's pretty much my Christmas. It was a good Christmas.
I don't celebrate Christmas.
Yeah, me neither. The best gift, no present I got was to be alone for 4 days and just play RuneScape.
Same.
I got a dragon dildo. No, I'm just kidding. I got nothing.
I'm surprised.
Even mine's
that.
Better than that. Wait, didn't you laugh at my half an orange and you didn't get anything? Fuck you.
Mate, I don't celebrate Christmas, so.
Yeah, no, do I, so I half an orange.
I got scammed for big bones, so.
I think getting half an orange would be more disrespectful than getting nothing.
Well, I like oranges, so yep.
Well, you got a half one, so. Not an orange.
Yeah, man, that was pretty good. Half my five a day.
What about you, Randy?
My Christmas was pretty great. Got quite a bit of money.
Come my world, Birthrope Games Room.
All right, we're 3 hours into this bitch. If no one, anyone else have anything? Anyone else have anything they want to add in before we end it here?
If you made it this far, thanks for listening, guys. It was a lot of fun, a lot of laughs.
Yeah,
a few disconnections. That I think I disconnected 4 or 5 times.
Something like that. Yeah.
There's a lot of things that go on. That.
I got the times written down, so hopefully it's not bad. But all right, that'll wrap it up for this podcast. Thanks for watching. Really enjoyed this. 3 hours long. Eventually, I think we might build up to it being like a 24-hour podcast. Who the hell knows?
Life
keeps getting longer every single podcast.
All right, next podcast will be coming out January 10th or 11th, one of those 2 days. That's to be determined. But thank you a lot for watching, and we really appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Good fun.
Lastly, if you have any topic ideas, questions, comments, concerns, or anything like that, leave a comment below, or there is a form in the description. You can fill that out if you like to. One or the other. It's up to you. But thanks for watching, guys.